Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Red Pill Tamales. I know a lot of y'all are very curious as to how did a lifelong Democrat, how did this Mr. Can't Deport Us All dude, you know, how did he just switch over to the dark side? Why did he vote for Trump? We've been talking about this, man, episode after episode after episode. We calling out the bullshit. We calling out the hypocrisy. We want to arm y'all with the tools of critical thinking. We want to inform y'all so y'all could be empowered. We want y'all to know both sides of the argument, because it's real easy to pull the wool over people's eyes.
Definitely.
And hit them with the okie doke, because shit be sounding real fly. Anyway, real quick, man, shout out to all the patrons, bro. We got new people signing up every day. Thank you guys so much. Some people even voluntarily up their membership on their own. Nadie les dijo nada,
wey. Nada.
Solitos. Because they want that whole enchilada, baby, that red pill tamal. Sas. And if you want to join and you want to get all the bonus episodes, the chingo chats, that's the non-political talk, exclusive stuff. We drop multiple times a week.
Yep.
All they got to do is go to patreon.com/redpill.
That's it. And if it's too difficult, you just have to search Chingo Bling or Red Pill Tamales on Patreon, and you're absolutely gonna find the page. We actually just did a welcome video. We didn't have one up. Not a lot of people have them up on nowadays. Like early on, having a welcome video was kind of like, you gotta have one, right? Mm-hmm. But now people know who they're going to go support. Mm-hmm. So if you have one, it's kind of just for fun. So we have a little welcome video that tells you guys what's up, what's going down. It was a one take. It was fun. Go check it out and then sign up after you watch it.
Yeah, absolutely, man. So go and just take a look at what all we have to offer. And Rob and I had a meeting the other day about a lot of cool tweaks and changes and things we want to do for the Patreon. So just be on the lookout for how we're going to maybe revamp the tiers and just try to give you more.
Right.
And bring more people over just to see, even if it's at a basic level, we just want more people in the introductory to just kind of know that, hey, Rob and Chingo don't sound crazy. They sound like reasonable people.
Yeah.
They don't really be throwing out random conspiracy stuff with no backing, no source. You know, use your brain, man. Y'all motherfuckers ain't stupid. Real quick, man, I'm hitting the road. Thank you. It is a Biden miracle. Thank you, Mr. Overlord Joe Biden, for opening up the economy. Thank you so much. Thank you to the CCP for making the... I don't want to be in the FEMA camps, bro. I'm not trying to be in the FEMA camps. I'm trying to get back to work and exercise my right to talk shit. The Freedom of Speech Tour is coming March 13th, San Angelo, Texas. You already know. That's over there at the Beauregard. Por favor, believe it. I think we're going to do it all VIP. Everybody's going to be VIP.
Ooh.
Everybody gets an autograph album, Versace Mariachi. We have Mission, Texas, March 26th. We have New Braunfels, Texas, April 3rd. Then we head over to Brea, California, April 7th. Hopefully that one doesn't get postponed, because you know how it is over there with Governor Newsom.
Yep.
You know, they're trying to recall him, and he's on total recall backlash.
Which, that we'll talk about that as well, because some sketchy shit going on with him.
Uh-oh. We're going to talk about Governor DeSantis? I want to call him DeSantis.
That's what I want to say, too, but people are like DeSantis.
DeSantis. No, fuck that. DeSantis. DeSantis, güey. And we're going to talk about Governor Cuomo. But just last tour date I want to announce, Killeen, Texas, April 9th and April 10th. Looking forward to that. Por favor, believe.
All right, you got to shoot me those links, because I don't think they're on chingobling.com yet.
We're still building the link. So okay. Yesterday, Mighty Soul was on Eventbrite, setting up all the San Angelo, gotcha, making sure that everything is typed in there correctly and nobody's expecting something like, hey, I thought I was going to get preferred seating with this, and what the fuck?
Yeah. Know? Well, when they're done, because these are all the... Are you guys running these? Like, are you guys handling the tickets and the for these shows?
I think all of them except for Mission, Texas.
Okay. Well, yeah, send them to me. So it's just easier. You don't have to set up every link on chinglebling.com. But while you're there, everybody, sign up for the newsletter. Kind of shop around. Check out what's going on chinglebling.com.
Especially in the day and age of people being afraid of getting deplatformed, because you're not really allowed to ask certain questions or bring up certain issues without running the risk of getting kicked off of YouTube and kicked out of the public square, as they call it. So please sign up to the email blast. We definitely, so many departments around here, so many little things that we have to stay on top of. Rob's doing a great job of managing Marisol's podcast, my podcast, making sure the clips are going up on the YouTube, making sure the patrons are taken care of. So at some point, we'll make sure that the email blast is well done.
Yeah. Have you started using any other app or software or platform like Gab or Telegram or Signal? Have you downloaded any of them and fucked with any of them?
Well, I had downloaded Parler. Then I started hearing that was like a, what'd they say? Like a, basically it was like the feds, like a honeypot.
Oh, really?
Like just to get a bunch of crazies in there. And
I did hear that, like,
I don't know if that's true. Speaking of Gab, gab.com, I have not signed up. But the dude, I think he's like the CEO or the founder. Mm. Man, I heard him on a podcast, bro.
Yeah?
Now, you know if I'm whispering. Shit about to get real interesting. Homeboy was on a podcast basically saying that you're going to start hearing more stories coming from the mainstream left media, like your NPR, attacking Christians. Straight up. It's already episode out. I already heard it. I let my 12-year-old hear it. Hey, baby, this is National Public Radio. I want you to use your own brain and your own critical thinking skills and see if any words pop out, if anything sounds strange. I let her play it, and they're basically saying stuff like this. We have seen a rise in white evangelicals, white nationalist evangelicals, and they're promoting conspiracy theories like the big lie. There are literally pastors out there at these southern churches saying that Joe Biden was not elected officially. And it's like, basically, and then they cut to a talking head, of course, it's well produced. They're basically trying to pitch you this idea that y'all need to beware of these Southern Baptists, of these evangelical Christian whites. And then the way they describe one of the churches, they're like, they gathered before going in, you know, lots of, you know, they're just meandering outside, most of them white. And then they go on to, it's like, what's going on here? Why?
I was trying to find who funds it, because for the longest time, I remember hearing that they're pretty, like, governmentally funded, I guess.
Yeah, like, tax funded.
Right. So, but
NPR.
Yeah, it's just one of those things, like, how unbiased is a source like that, right? Not very.
Well, everybody's biased, and every institution, every publication is going to be somewhat biased.
But with a name like, you know, National Public Radio. Yeah. The people don't understand that. They're going there for information, thinking that it is unbiased.
It's national. It's public.
Yeah, and everyone's going to get to hear from all the sides equally, all that shit. That's not really what happens a lot of times.
Nah, bro. It's just the mainstream narrative left, and they were conflating a lot of stuff. They were basically making it sound like you got these crazy... This is what they're trying to do, Rob.
Hit me.
They're trying to say, make the argument... They're laying the groundwork that these white evangelical churches that mix politics into their, you know, their church. One of it's called like the Patriot Church in Knoxville, Tennessee and stuff like that. Or some of them on their Instagram, some of the preachers, they'll be posting pretty right, you know, conservative or Republican, whatever. And this is what they're trying to do. They're saying the same way that you have radical Islamists in ISIS, and they're kind of doing terrorist type stuff, you have radical Christian people that are doing domestic. It's what they're trying to, they're basically saying the same way extreme Islamists run their countries with religious law. Y'all look out, because these crazy white boy preachers are trying to run America like this crazy theocracy, and they want to impose their religion, and they want to say that America is a Western male Christian patriarchy, and don't let them do it, because that's the domestic terrorism, that's vanilla ISIS, and y'all got to watch out, because they promote conspiracies.
Real it sounds shit. So dumb, though.
Yeah,
but that's really the world we're living in.
Yeah, but they present it in a way to where they're promoting the big lie. Dangerous conspiracies, you know? And then the way they edit the stuff and take stuff out of context, and they'll pick out extreme examples and try to do a blanket approach. And my daughter, she goes to a private school that's like, I guess, I don't know what kind of church that is. It might be Baptist or something. I don't know.
Okay.
Private school. So her hearing this stuff, she's like, oh my God, Dad, like, are they trying to persecute Christians? And I'm like, shh. You don't want to end up in the camps with me. Save yourself.
You're so dumb.
Shh. And then, that shit intrigued me. So then I look on, there's this other podcast. I know Steve Bannon got a crazy reputation. They paint him like motherfucking Hitler's right-hand man and shit, right? So Steve Bannon has a podcast called like Pandemic War Room. And they put out like 40-minute clips every day. He'll have like Dr. Peter Attia. He'll have Dr. Shiva. He had one of these pastors on. He had the CEO of Gab on. And the founder of Gab, whatever, I forget his name. He was basically saying, look, man, the left, they're going after Christians. He was saying, we need to decouple from this mainstream economy. He's like, because they could just kick you off whenever they want. He says, we need to start thinking, do my values align with this social media platform? Do my values align, I guess these days, with this soda?
Yeah. Oh, dude, right? Speaking of Coca-Cola, because I didn't get to read the whole thing. How much of it do you know? Because when you see the headline, like Coca-Cola staff told online training seminar, try to be less white.
Yeah.
The first thing I thought, I love Coke Zero. I even have some of the, I'll drink some of the fucking Coke energy, coffee fucking things.
You ever had HEB Zero?
No.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah?
Come on to the dark side.
Bro. Really? Okay.
But Luisa swears by it. My babysitter, she's like, hey, faltan cocas. Las del cero. Las del heeb.
No, man, it's just, it's frustrating because like there's so many things to keep up with. And that one was on my list to really dive into, but I haven't yet. But just that in general, that is something that's being thrown out into the world to Coca-Cola employees and now the world, because I guess a whistleblower leaked it, try to be less white. I told my wife, hey, stop being white.
Stop being white. Hey, you being, you're not, what is it? You're not listening and believing.
Yeah.
So Ben Shapiro did a good breakdown of it. The way he was kind of breaking it down, he was saying that there's this lady, man, I forget her name. I need to have all my sources. There's a lady, she wrote a book called White Fragility. I forget her name, but she gets paid by big corporations.
Oh, the lady with the glasses?
I think
and
so.
And the curly hair, keep on.
Yeah. So the lady, I think, wrote the book White Fragility. One of her other hustles is to get paid by big corporations to come in and basically give y'all some racial cultural sensitivity, kind of get you caught up to speed with the new normal, because some of y'all too white, basically, right? Some of y'all a little bit too vanilla, and y'all need some flavor. So companies like Coca-Cola, they understand that if they're perceived as conservative, which I mean they're probably not, but if they're perceived as conservative, their popularity, their approval rating goes down like 30%. So they're just like, fuck it, man. Look, these conservatives ain't finna boycott us. These liberals will. Let's just make sure that nobody tries to call us out for being too white or too conservative. Let's go ahead and cut the check. Give the lady her $35K, whatever she charges, to come in here in the conference room, pull up her PowerPoint, and berate these white people and tell them how bad they are for being Caucasian.
Robin DiAngelo, right?
Robin DiAngelo.
This crazy kooky lady, the Wi-Fi gentleman, ladies and gentlemen, I want to pull some clips up, but she had said some crazy shit just on national TV about just being white, and basically saying, she even said, she went as far as to say, you can't as a white person say that you're not racist. Basically, every white person, you are absolutely to a degree a level racist, no matter what you say, don't deny it. Actually, if you deny it, it's even worse looking on you.
So there's
what?
Like, I know, bro. And guess what? You and I looked at as the crazy ones. You and I,
oh my God,
are part of the side that my own raza, bro, man, the fucking, these little cholos with keyboards, bro, they looking at me like I'm stupid. They looking at me right now like Chingo done lost his motherfucking marbles. Meanwhile, y'all over there buying that Coke, sipping that Coca-Cola, not knowing that they're fucking, what is this money they spending? Like, I don't even think Coke believes this stuff. They just getting ahead of it, like, just in case we get sued, we could be like, hey,
we tried.
We train these motherfuckers not to be white.
They can't help it.
Some of these crackers don't listen.
They love their guns and their flag, and they keep saying that, you know, we love everybody, but we don't agree with that.
Talking about they love Jesus.
Come on, man.
Ain't no room for that over
Jesus,
here.
Jesus, get out of here.
Get that flag on. I seen the flag on your car. God. It said 1776 on it. Okay.
It's a lie.
So we see it as odd because the whistleblower, somebody that works at Coke, took pictures of the PowerPoint.
Yeah.
And it's like, look at the tenets that it says. It says you got to learn to be more humble. Basically, don't fight back. Don't talk back. Just believe and listen. So if somebody's telling you hey, there's racism and I'm a victim because I'm Mexican and y'all too white for me and you're oppressing me. You can't be like, no, I'm not. It's like, motherfucker, I said you are.
Sus.
So that's part of the tenets. And I even heard Cartoon Network is running these little PSAs to indoctrinate the kids, talking about basically, what's her name? Robin DiAngelo?
Mm-hmm.
Basically like some Robin DiAngelo type shit, but for the kids.
Really?
Saying like, this is what they're saying. They're saying, if we don't see color, we'll never be empathetic to the plight of others. So we have to start seeing color so that we could be more sensitive to the plight of others. And it's like, wait, I thought the civil rights movement taught us judge us on the content of our character and don't look at the color of the skin. Go by the content of the character.
Right.
And now y'all over here brainwashing folks saying, you need to see color. Uta madre.
What a dangerous precedent to throw out there to start rolling into Cartoon Network, into the world in general, but into our kids. Like,
people don't see it though, bro.
They don't see. Just what if you just like sat down and repeated the words that some of these people say on TV? What if you just sat down and I'm just talking to people out loud, like in general. Like if you have friends or family that disagree with what you're saying, like the sentiment of how dangerous that is or how dumb it, fuck dangerous, it's just dumb.
Yeah.
Have them repeat it. Print the transcript, pull up the videos, sit down and watch them together and look at the person who's disagreeing with you and just be like, okay, she just said all people are racist. You got to see things based off skin color. You got to, and then just kind of see if they nudge a little bit like, yeah, you're right, that is kind of dumb. If they don't, you got to lose them as a friend. You got to just disassociate. That's a dangerous person to have around you. They're never going to not be oppressed, even if they're not really.
Dangerously stupid.
Dangerously stupid. And they're allowed to vote.
Yeah. And they're on autopilot right now because their guy won.
Yeah.
And there's kids in cages. Today is February 23rd. February 23rd. Actually, look, shout out to this patron, man. We just Edwin Aleman, which 6 minutes ago just signed up to the patreon.com/redpilltamales.
Holla.
So this discussion that we're having is designed to kind of wake people up and let people know, hey man, this might not be a big deal today, but if every corporation starts to be hostage and pay the Robin DiAngelos of the world, number one, telling white people they're bad, number one. Now you're just about to piss off white people. now you're just all persecuting white people, telling them stop being so white, stop being white. That shit, what? That don't make no goddamn sense.
No goddamn sense. I just wanted to pull up a random clip of her because you know she's on this tour, this PR tour. It seems like, or at least her clips are resurfacing because of what you know happened with Coca-Cola.
The whistleblowers
kind of made it all repopulate. And I haven't seen any of her videos directly without just being clips, you know, of her and you know 15 seconds here or there. But I'm just interested of like what her long form conversations could potentially have. But
I saw one clip.
Okay.
Where it might have been one that you said she had like big hair.
Yes, I think, okay. She has, okay.
I think that was her. And she was just basically like, I know this is going to sound crazy to y'all, but y'all racist and ain't nothing you can do, but maybe stop being so white. But even if you don't think you're racist, deep down inside, you're racist. And I'm like, what are you talking about?
Okay, so I actually have one here. Just randomly that first one I clicked on was with her and Jimmy Fallon, which damn, Jimmy Fallon's looking old as shit.
Jimmy Fallon.
I used to love Jimmy Fallon too.
Let's see if it plays.
Dr. Robin DiAngelo, thank you so much for doing the Tonight Show. I really appreciate it. I know how busy you are and everyone wants to talk to you right now. So this means a lot to me. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
And thank you so much for having me.
Oh, okay.
Your book, White Fragility, Why It's So Hard for White People to Talk About Racism. This came out in 2018.
Yes.
And it's been on the bestseller list ever since then.
It has, yes.
And right now it is number one on all the lists I looked at. And it's also from what I read, it's sold out everywhere as well.
An unfortunate time for it to be sold out, but yes.
Yeah. Well, here's what I did. I got it on Kindle.
Ah, okay.
I don't know if you saw this. It went viral online. A flight attendant was greeting people on her plane.
Exceptional.
Fuck up, Jim.
But just, let's just Fallon. Notice that would be exceptional. You know, there's a question I often ask when I'm in front of a mixed race group. And I ask the black people in the room a kind of rhetorical question. How often have you attempted to give a white person feedback on their inevitable and often unaware racist.
Sorry, y'all, the Wi-Fi.
Damn, she was about to get to some stupid point.
Shout out to the patrons.
Shout out to the patrons making it happen. We'll hardwire some internet pretty soon.
I wonder, we just got to get like a long ass cord, right?
Dude, I'm going to do that next time. When I come on Thursday, I'm going to get a 200 fucking foot cord.
200 yards.
And hardwire it from the inside back here.
Straight to the Ethernet.
Straight to the goddamn Ethernet.
Passed into the Matrix.
Is this even that? Okay, so it's still buffering. But the point is, you can hear that she was about to say is,
are you on the right Wi-Fi, bro?
Assumptions are behaviors. And have that go well for you. Never. Number two, response, rarely. And I'll never forget asking a group, okay, so what if you could just give us feedback on our inevitable and often unaware racist assumptions and behaviors? And I'll never forget.
Look at Jimmy Fallon's face. He's like, what the fuck am I talking to?
It would be revolutionary. Oh, and you're just take
Jimmy, she's telling you a racist to your face, you big dummy.
That's dumb. I can't hear anymore
stupid.
Of that. Well,
pinches mamadas, güey.
You know, that if that doesn't make you want to mock and make fun of absolutely everything going on in the world right now, I don't know what will.
But, you know, people have been brainwashed that everything is white supremacy. Now, you have racism, obviously. Mm-hmm. That exists. There might be some systemic systems that kind of perpetuate inequality. For example, these teachers unions not letting these kids go back to school, that's racist. Bruh. Because you're setting up systemic racism. You want these kids to fail. They're what's the word, man? They're saying all these kids got ADD now, supposedly. Only because they're distracted, they're on a computer, they're trying to learn through the computer, but they're playing games on another window and they're just fiddling, you know. That's just a byproduct of this bullshit situation we're in. But
What else did Mickey's like? Did she? What did you have her listen to? Was it the podcast or just a clip?
I had her listen to the NPR version where they were trying to scare people that these white evangelical Christians are promoting the big lie, which is a conspiracy theory. It's baseless that Joe Biden really didn't win, and they were saying, X amount percentage of Republicans don't believe Biden really won, and X amount of evangelicals don't believe Biden really won, and Trump took advantage of the evangelicals when he ran in 2016 by making their grievances part of his campaign, and blah, 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 blah. I used to listen to that, like The Daily and NPR and until I figured out New York Times is full of shit and Washington Post full of shit and the mainstream media is full of shit. They got you on some crash dummy shit. If you listen to the mainstream media, you're fucked because they're not going to tell you anything useful about your health, anything useful about like your money, your pockets, what the important shit for your family. All they doing is leading you off a fucking cliff like a crash dummy. That's all they're doing. They telling you that all the psyop shit. They're like, oh, this was a coup. This was an insurrection. How was that an insurrection?
Sol sent me a really good clip. You follow at DC Drano, it is. Mm-hmm. Did you see the one he posted earlier? I don't know if Sol sent it to you or if you had to happen to have seen it. All these Democrats that are so upset having voted for Joe Biden.
Mm. Are they like screenshots?
Yeah.
Oh, there's a ton of those. I don't know if they're all real, but there's a ton of them. Like, where's my stimmy? And
even that is just like, Biden just said whatever necessary to get elected.
Yeah, and y'all fell for it. But guess what? Mexican-Americans ain't seeing it.
I'm too broken to be pissed. Keep going, sorry.
Mexican-Americans don't see it.
Do you think this time, next cycle, it's good? Like, people will see, enough people have been red-pilled to where, basically, what's the saying? Like, if there is a lot of, we'll call it irregularities or crazy nonsense that happens, right? Mm-hmm. Do you think that there is enough of a chance that you could be so undeniable that even if they are committing some crazy acts, they still can't overcome or overshadow the amount of people that are just like, nah, fuck that shit. We're going to vote this way now because that's complete nonsense. No matter how much they try to, you know,
pull
some shenanigans.
Well, I think some people feel that they just kind of apathy. I think a lot of people feel the Republicans are bad too because Ted Cruz went to Cancun when he should have been on the power line giving y'all power. He should he should have been passing out water bottles. So there you go, Chingo. The Republicans are just as bad. It's two wings. Okay, I'm not a cheerleader for the Republicans. I mean, you could be libertarian, you could be independent. I don't give a damn what you are. However, what I'm seeing is some extreme hypocritical fucking bullshit propaganda. Well, don't get me wrong. There's propaganda on both sides. They're going to do fake news on Joe, just like they did on Trump. But I feel like some people have that apathy where they're like, you see, Chingo, it don't matter, because no matter what, we're screwed and we just got to focus on what we got to do, and ain't shit we could do. It's like, okay, meanwhile, while you have that attitude, the Democratic Party got the boot on your neck because they're straight up lying to you. They're the ones calling for violence. They're the ones inciting violence. They're the ones turning a blind eye, letting Antifa act a fool. I'm keeping it a buck. I'm keeping it 100 with everybody that's listening right now. The shit that I'm saying makes sense.
There you go. That's the point I was just about to make. How do we get to a point or phrase things that we're trying to say to a point that it just makes sense? Almost like you're not voting left or right. You're just voting for what makes most sense. Like in your heart of hearts, if you even have one, or in your soul of soul, if you believe in souls, could you just look at the bullet points, the policies, the things happening, that actual things transpiring, and say, that makes more sense than that?
I think there's a lot of factors. I think, like, number one, people can lie with statistics. You know, they could lie with numbers and data and be like, see, look at this graph.
I think there's a book that's like Statistics Lie or something like that.
Yeah, How to Lie with Statistics.
That's what it is, yeah.
I'd like to read it just to see what type of stunts they're pulling on us. There's another good book called Loser Think. I have the audio version, but I kind of want to get like the hard copy. But Loser Think shows you how experts, you know, don't really have critical thinking in a way. Like experts are like, what? How dare you compare this to the flu? And let me explain this. And then it's like, okay, well, that's not what I said. You're misinterpreting. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, where are the flu deaths?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Do people really die of the flu? Or y'all just been inflating that all this time?
Well, I think in the last like 4 weeks, like El Virus is down like 70%. 77%, I think it is. It's a fucking miracle.
El Virus de la C?
El Virus de
la... La mera mera de que viene de allá?
La que no puedes decir.
Ah, esa no. Esa okay. No. El Virus.
El Virus.
El Virus or El Virus?
That's a shirt.
El pinche virus me la pela.
El pinche virus.
The one that 77%. Got the 98% recovery rate or whatever.
The one that the U.S. taxpayers are funding in that one place?
The lab.
Las taxas del...
Yeah. The lab and allá en el Wu.
Uh-huh.
Allá en el lab.
Tus taxas.
Your tax dollars, you fucking asshole.
Are ours, I guess, at this point because of everything.
Well, yeah, our, yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
All you people to call me a sellout, guess what? All your tax dollars just went to the Wuhan lab. All the people calling me a coconut, talking about Chingo's crazy, all your tax dollars just went back to fund the World Health Organization. Get ready for the gulags. They gonna put y'all in there.
Oh, God.
Let me just say this, too. If you follow me on Instagram, Real Chingo Bling, that is the suppressed version of me. That is not even me. My Instagram, that ain't even... It might as well... This is a great idea.
Okay.
I might as well just hand it over to somebody because I can't even really do what I want to do. I can't say what I want to say. I do all that shit on the What Did He Said page. If you go to @WhatDidHeSaid, I come at you unfiltered, you know, straight no chaser. We putting it out there. We putting memes up there. We talking about the important shit. Over here on the Real Chingo Bling Instagram, I'm just going to put something that's not going to trigger nobody. Nobody can misinterpret. I got to walk on fucking eggshells on my Instagram because y'all can't handle it. Because either I don't know who to blame. Either the educational system, that bullshit entertainment y'all consume, or that bullshit mainstream media. But Pancho Villa will be ashamed of y'all. Pancho Villa will be ashamed. He'd kick you off your horse. Like, bitch, get in the house. We going to war, ho. Get in the fucking house. You can't ride with us. Pancho Villa will be ashamed. You be over there, get over there and make some goddamn beans for the soldiers. Get the fire started for the soldiers. You ain't take them bullets off your chest. You ain't riding with us. Because people like Rob and myself are sticking our necks out, you know, taking a risk of I mean, shit, I haven't seen no effect on my tour because it hasn't been no tour.
Yeah.
Because of the CCP virus. I'm sorry, el virus.
El virus.
Perdón, el virus. But yeah, don't follow me on Instagram at Real Chingo Bling because that ain't even really me. I might as well just hand that to somebody. Just somebody who knows how to not offend people. So y'all wanted Chingo Bling to keep it raw, but y'all don't want Chingo Bling to really express himself. Y'all want a watered down version of the shit that's not going to upset you. And to answer your question further, you said, what is it going to take so that maybe 4 years from now, people can start to make a shift? Okay, number one, do you think the Biden administration is going to spend time and energy and resources trying to improve the transparency of our selections? Let's just call them that.
Ah.
Do you think they're going to have, you honestly think, you little normies out there, where the camera at?
Where's my camera?
All you little bozos out there, bottom you little one. Normies out there.
Bottom one, there you go.
Oh, the bottom one. You little normies over there, believe in the fucking mainstream media, you normies really think that this administration is going to spend some time, energy, effort, and resources trying to improve the transparency of our selections. You out your motherfucking mind if you think that's a priority. So guess what? They still going to run these little games. There's still going to be a cabal of elite... whatever the fuck they said.
I used to think that word was so stupid.
A cabal?
Yeah. And then you see it in Time magazine, and I'm like, man, they just solidified any use of that word ever in the past because it's real. It's as real as it gets when it is, you know, put in Time magazine with what happened.
Pinches mamadas.
Oh, it's so funny. See, what you just did, this good little 5-10 minute rant on that particular subject, mm-hmm. might just be what patrons get to do for you on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And I'm spitballing. I haven't even told Chingo this, uh-huh. but just maybe, you know, patrons get to tell you stuff that they would like to hear your take on, your hot take.
Okay.
And then you just sit back here, and in a way, you get to talk about it, work on that Bill Burr, Chingo Bling style of like spitting fucking game. And then also you might get some good bits out of it.
Yeah. Yeah. I would definitely love to utilize this time to just be a better listener, a better communicator, better persuader, because right now it's the war of ideas. We're literally at war right now. Yeah. I mean, we're being hit economically. The American people are being victimized by propaganda, but y'all motherfuckers don't see it. You know, and again, like I said, I'm not gonna go out of my way to save all y'all.
We have a platform here, we have an audience that's coming mm-hmm. to the platform. We're not Perfect. Necessarily going out there and saying, hey, I'm gonna rope all these people from the left or who are, you know, moderate lefts or whatever to come over here. They will find their way here. God and they willing. Will join the TIA.
God willing.
Right?
God willing.
And once they sign up for the TIA, they will do the duty of getting out there and sharing it with their friends and family or acquaintances or on their, you know, social medias mm-hmm. or whatever. And then those people that like that will also come. We can't possibly go and try to lasso all these motherfuckers that disagree or all these motherfuckers that want to use your keyboards to really be like, well, what you don't get is this, mm-hmm. this, and that. And it's like, okay, hey, man.
You know who I know we can persuade? The hood smart motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Like, I guarantee you, it could be a little huddle of dudes hanging out in front of a store or something. And if we're having a real conversation, it might be easier to just let motherfuckers know, like, okay, because they already don't trust certain things. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, I don't know, man. 2020 was just such an interesting year that, you know, this is when I was opening my eyes up. And I was witnessing 2020. There was so much going on. And I was already up on game up at that point.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, just before, I can't remember when exactly. I wish I had a date when I was like, oh, Trump really didn't say that.
I kind of wish he did too.
I wish I did have a date. It might have been like...
well, let's just pretend, like, let's just paint the picture.
I would, if I had to hypothetically guess, it'd be somewhere towards middle end of 2019, let's just say. Let's just say, only because by the time the el virus
yeah.
was making its way, you know, when I first heard about the virus, they said...
Oh, you kind of talked about this like Christmas time 2019 or like Thanksgiving 2019, I think. Because weren't you out of town and then came back from somewhere?
Is that when the water line broke from we went to Kansas City. I can't remember that exact date, but we went to Kansas City. We landed, and I had been hearing about... I need to rewind a little bit. When I first heard about El Virus,
yeah,
the news, quote-unquote, news that they were giving us from across the ocean over there, y'all know what I'm talking about? They were saying, oh, don't nothing to worry about, y'all. The World Health Organization just said it doesn't go from human...
Oh, it doesn't transmit. It's
species, you know, right. Human to human. We're good. If you're human, you good. If you're a bat, you're fucked.
Dijo el CCP.
Dijo el pinche CCP y el pinche el WHO, el WHO, güey, del virus. So there was a point in time where I was like, oh, okay, we're good, we're good. This novel coronavirus, whatever the fuck, we good. It shit don't go, it don't jump species. It's not transmissible human to human. Okay, they thought it was a couple cases, but it's good. It ain't spread. Meanwhile, they lying to us. Now it's harder for them to suppress the info. Now it's getting out. Like, no, bitch, this shit is for real and it's spreading and supposedly it's deadly and it's going to fuck you up. By that point, that's when the water pipes had busted on the east side of Houston.
Oh, yeah.
We landed from Kansas City at the airport. You couldn't get coffee. You couldn't get nothing. Everybody was closed. They're like, sorry, y'all, the water lines thing and we can't do shit. So we're like, fuck, we just landed. Now we got to haul ass somewhere and go buy a bunch of cases of water. And I told Marisol, I said, hey, babe, we need to get some big old thing of Purell because there's this virus and, you know, we're going to have to not be touching shit. And how we going to, you know what I mean? We were already thinking ahead. How is VIP going to happen? What's up with meet and greets? Are they going to hurry up and figure out, is it vitamin D? Is it hydroxychloroquine? You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Shit you can't talk about. Because you normies have empowered the mainstream narrative, bro. And we can't even have this discussion properly.
Okay, so then that happens, right? And we're closing on 2019. Just let's paint a fun picture here. If you can't remember exactly what happened, let's just pretend that you do. And okay. What started to, like, you know, kind of stir things up and open your mind a little bit?
About all this. About all this. Left, right. Man, like I said, I got to give props to Scott Adams because on his podcast... You know, he would decipher fake news and how things are taken out of context. He'll even defend Biden. He'll be like, y'all know he ain't mean that shit like that. You know what I'm saying?
I hold your thought because I don't want you to forget it. But there's a video that just literally I was seeing this morning for the first time. I hadn't seen it throughout the weekend or anything. Of him giving, it was like a virtual conference that he was giving for something or to somewhere.
Biden?
Yeah, Biden. Okay. And he totally has like a slip of words and says the N-word. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Did you see it?
Yeah.
There was no place for that word in the middle anywhere in what he was saying.
Yeah, he was saying, I'm eager,
yeah.
And he's old.
He's just old.
And you're not even allowed to say how old he is. You're not, bro, if you sit here and tell people this man is showing signs of cognitive decline, this man has already had multiple brain surgeries.
Keep going.
Multiple brain surgeries. First of all, he done had a whole facelift. They gave this man new cheekbones, new hair. He'd been bald since the fucking 80s. All of a sudden, he got this, this shit is quaffed up. You're not even really allowed to bring up that argument because people on the left are like, shut up, Trump supporter, crazy conspiracy insurrectionist, orange man bad. It's like, y'all motherfuckers don't see how old he is?
He, like I was going to say, it kind of makes it, just as a human to human, it kind of makes you feel bad for the old fuck. Because he's withering away, sí, like, wey. So fast.
Pobrecito.
And funny enough, Trump is the only president, I think, in modern day history that, I mean, since I've been alive, that you can't necessarily go from, like, the 4 years before to the 4 years after and see, like, the graying decay of his hair and his skin and his personality. He literally came out just like... Let's start filming a show now, you know? Meanwhile, everyone else looks like they've aged 20 years.
Well, how about this? Joe Biden is rocking a tan right now.
Is he?
Yeah, there's pictures, man. He got that tan, and ain't nobody finna make fun of his ass. Let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Can the Jimmy Fallons and the Trevor Noahs of the world and the Jimmy Kimmels, are they allowed to make fun of the administration right now? Can they clown Kamala? Can they poke fun at Joe?
I don't think they can right now. This is just me personally thinking. I think it's too soon. I think they think it's too soon.
It's a honeymoon?
Yeah. No jabs, no nothing, no subtle little clips or anything.
Let him kill jobs real quick. Let him do about 55 executive orders.
He's already there. He's over 50.
Oh my god.
I want to find this clip real quick.
Shout out to Del Rio, Texas, man. I hear that right now, not only are they dealing with a pandemic, they're dealing with high unemployment, and they're right there on the border. So I heard these cartels acting a fool and shit. So that's what maybe Biden and some of their policies, they're not really thinking about the Rio Grande Valley and Del Rio. They're not thinking about the border towns because they're about to cause them a whole lot of problems. Not only do you have oil jobs down there, but you're a border town. So you don't want a whole bunch of sex trafficking and shit, human trafficking going all through your little town and people pumping that dope through there.
While I see if this loads, since we're talking about Biden and mental decline, which I don't even know what you can say. Like, you don't want to, you can't, you know, the terms are a little...
People on the left worship, man. They worship that man. They don't want to hear it.
On a little bit lighter note, there was somebody tweeting about Kendall Jenner's tequila company. Did you see that by chance?
Briefly, vaguely.
I think she named it 818, right? Uh-huh. And is that a Cali thing?
I think so.
And they were just like, somebody tweeted that like, basically, how dare you, you know, take away from Mexicans, basically, my family who are in the fields and have used their hands to make these great spirits, and you're over here, you know, capitalizing on that. I'm like,
she not allowed to sell tequila?
What the fuck? Yeah, exactly.
Man, look here. Jenny Rivera got a tequila company. If you're not supporting some of these Mexican-owned tequila companies... If I open up a tequila company, y'all probably gonna boycott me. Talking about this fool ain't Mexican, fool. You better go sell some whiskey with that bullshit, Chingo.
You'd be like, I've been talking about ranch water for 2 years, y'all.
I mean, shit. Goddamn. Let Kylie get her hustle on, man. She wanna name it 818, let her name it 818. If you don't like it, don't buy it. But guess what? That Patron y'all be drinking, who owns that? The white man. Paul Mitchell, the shampoo man, owns, and then George Clooney, he just sold his for a couple billy.
Yeah.
Casamigos.
Yep.
All these companies owned by white people. Why y'all picking on this Kardashian? Why? Because she's young? What's the problem? Did she say fuck Mexicans? I mean, what's the problem? Did she exploit her workers? What's the issue? Where is the crime? Y'all just mad because y'all ain't got y'all's own shit.
It really is frustrating.
I mean, who's mad? Who?
Just people on Twitter, which is literally nobody. You know, we've made this such of a big deal. Okay, we've made this such a big deal that I don't know how soon people can see that the numbers of people that are on Twitter.
Was Cristela crying over it?
Dude, again, I didn't know who that person was until the whole thing on our what did he said page or whatever the fuck, and I tried to go and just be like, who is this person? What do they do? And I couldn't get a chuckle at half the shit that she says, which whatever. But that's the kind of shit that's just annoying. Like, I mean, whatever, to each their own, do your thing, get your money. But people that are on Twitter up in arms about anything and everything every day has to be exhausting. It has to be exhausting.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, I'd be on there too complaining about shit like...
Yeah, I mean, but you're not like crying and trying to like change people's mind and cancel businesses.
If anything,
they don't get to get money and they don't get to start businesses because what?
Yeah, if anything, I'll be on there crying, complaining, talking about, look at how corny y'all look trying to boycott Goya.
Yeah, just pointing out all the dumb shit.
Y'all corny, bro. Man, get off the boo-boo.
Like, we could call that complaining and crying, sure, but it's like, I'm being funny about it. I'm trying to pick fun at all the nonsense, the nonsensical shit going on.
And I feel like I'm in a bubble because I'm probably not even reaching nobody that needs to be reached. Ain't nobody spread. I don't know. My shit ain't spreading how it needs to be spread, or people don't hear it how it needs to be heard. But, shit. I mean, the world, man, the world. What the fuck is going on? Maybe I'm getting old. Maybe I'm getting old.
You're definitely getting old.
I'm getting old and grumpy.
Definitely getting old and grumpy.
I'm getting old and grumpy, yelling at the TV, talking about 55 executive orders. What the fuck is this? Coca-Cola, get off the boo-boo.
You're going to be the old guy in The Simpsons, like either Homer's dad or his friend in the old folks home, where you're just like, I want some taquitos. Walking around.
The other day, it was a Monday. It was a Monday, right? Now, I'm 41, so yes, I'm getting old.
Yeah.
So we hop in the car. I think we were headed to the gym. We have our little coffee, And we got like this gospel playing. It's Kanye's choir.
Okay.
It's called Sunday Service.
You jamming it?
Oh, I love it.
Oh, yeah?
Every Sunday. Absolutely every Sunday, for sure.
Whatever.
But anyway, we're playing it on Monday. And we got the leather seats. And it smells a little bit like somebody been smoking.
Yeah.
Like cigarette. Like, what is that, weed? And I was like, I told my wife, I was like, we've officially turned into a little old black couple. And the reason I say that is because, number one, you hear the gospel playing. The neighbors are probably confused as shit. Like, is that the little Mexican family over there playing that? Hallelujah, hallelujah. And then the smell of like the leather with the like the smoke type of smell.
Yeah.
It reminds me of my friend Jason, his mom, Miss Debbie. When I was in high school, Miss Debbie is the lady that, along with my friend Jason, they really took me in. She really looked out for me. Like, she'd call home and give my sister an update. Like, he's good. He's not eating that much, but, you know, he eats like a little bird or whatever. But she used to pick us up in her Volvo. She'd go to Hightstown, New Jersey. They were from Neptune, New Jersey.
Okay.
Which is over there by Asbury Park, where your boy, the Jeep commercial man.
Oh, really?
Springsteen.
Who, by the way, starting a podcast with your boy.
With Obese.
Obese.
Double cringe.
We should do some Patreon exclusives and just listen in and do commentary on those podcasts.
Oh, my God.
Just two renegades born in the USA.
Massaging each other.
Jesus.
So Miss Debbie used to drive from Neptune with her mother,
uh-huh.
with Jason's grandma. They used to call her Medea. And she'd pull up in her Volvo. Leather seats. It smelled like cigarettes.
Yeah.
So that's my little memory of that. And she would always stop at this like flea market, a random flea market somewhere in between Hightstown, New Jersey and Neptune, where we would go stay, where I'd go kick it with them for a mm-hmm. weekend. And she'd buy these, she'd come back from inside from the place and she'd bring us these Italian New Jersey subs. I'm talking about with the oil and the vinegar and the lettuce and the tomato and the freshly sliced provolone, all the cheeses and the meats. And man, that's why I fuck with Jersey Mike's.
Some stuff. Shit you would hear Joey Diaz describe.
Oh, no, when I hear him talk about them sandwiches, I was like, y'all don't understand.
That's exactly what it is. That's y'all, how it was.
Yeah, I mean, for one, I was a kid, you know, you're a teenager, you're kind of hungry, and this sandwich is delicious. And
I've never been to a Jersey Mike's.
I like it. It's probably not as fresh and authentic as like what I just described.
Right.
I fuck with Jersey Mike's. I had it at the airport when I was stuck in Atlanta coming back from Florida.
There's one close to me. I have to check it out. All right, I give up looking for this clip. I think they actually removed it because of how hard Sky News. Because Sky News, you know, it's also cool because they have this like, you know, English, you know, the anchors Australian. And stuff. Australian, rather. And they have these accents where it's just like, it sounds so like professional, but mm-hmm. they're also like, they're taking jabs, like serious jabs at the mental decline of your boy. And
we're not allowed to say it. Nobody stateside.
Yeah.
They'll shoot you down.
Yeah, pretty much. And I think the video isn't on YouTube anymore,
honestly.
They'll just
be like, Chingo, come on. I mean, he's a great leader. He's going to undo all the bad things that dictator Trump did. And he's young. He's agile. Come on. This is Joe Biden.
It's just so...
He loves kids more than he loves people.
It makes you... Fuck, I gave up looking up. I couldn't find the computer, not finding it on my phone. But it makes you want to, when you're driving around... Just think, you know, to yourself, have you ever gotten to the state where you're driving around and then all of a sudden you come to and you forget you've been driving for the last 20 minutes and you're like, oh shit, like, let me focus because you've been getting to where you need to go, but not really like cognizant of the road.
Like autopilot.
Autopilot. Yeah. But luckily, you know, we know the mean streets of Houston, so we can navigate without actually paying attention.
Plus, there's a part of your brain that allows you to be able to, it's a part of like habit.
Mm.
So for example, I think it's this book called The Power of Habit by Charles Duhigg. He tells a story of this elderly gentleman who, although he had like mad dementia, he'd be able to like walk his neighborhood and loop back around no problem because the part of his brain that allowed him to do that was not the dementia part. It was more of an autopilot habit switch, like patterns. So the minute a house change color or they cut a tree or something throws them off, that's when it's like, uh-oh, grandpa's taking long. It's like, because they'd fuck up some
interesting
shit.
The point of that was that you get to the point where you're driving and you just like realize that, you know, you were driving, and but what you were thinking about was things of like, again, the absurdity of everything going on, like this person, this mental decline, not saying who, and then other people's oblivion to it, and then just denying it at all. And then you're like, man, where does this lead to? Where does this go, right? Does it lead to somebody taking over by default, you know, for the first time ever? I mean, in a long time. And then this person that takes over is also like the first woman who didn't win, but she's in there by default and has these radical ideas. And it's just like, man, give me all the popcorn and let me just see where this goes, because a certain side set this all in motion. And the other side has to witness it all kind of unfold, and also grab onto their businesses and their families closely, because you don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah, make sure you don't get deplatformed. Make sure you don't get kicked off of banking apps. Make sure you don't say the wrong thing. Make sure you don't try to red pill somebody. Make sure you don't go to the wrong church.
Like something on my Explorer feed popped up or made, I don't know why, but it was Jennifer Aniston's picture of when she was, I guess, voting by mail. You know, and her caption was like, you know, don't forget. I think actually that was the one where she said, don't write in Kanye. It's not funny. And then Kanye was like, well, neither was Friends or something. Which I'm guilty of liking Friends. I mean, that's just some shit Don and I will watch if it's on or whatever. But and then so I clicked on that. And then, you know, you just keep scrolling and it's other related images or reels or stories similar to that photo. And it led to another photo of a show. I don't want to mention it, but that I enjoy on network cable or TV, and they're all wearing masks, and the main star's wearing, it was two or three masks, and it's just like, one, I'm telling myself, why does this elicit such a response? I know it's, to me, it's dumb, it's unprovable that it works any better than anything else, and it was just so frustrating. I was like, all right, these people are all in on this rhetoric, and they're going to continue to until when? I just kind of think to myself.
Well, think about it, Rob. I mean, there are good arguments. Like, there are, what's the word, persuasive arguments as to why a mask could help. Although, there's all these variables, like, you know, you've mentioned before, like, are you washing it in an industrial hospital-type washing machine? Are you touching your face? Are you using the right kind? Are you wearing it properly? There's a shit ton of variables. So I definitely feel you on that. So thank God for Florida, because... Florida basically said, hey, we've been running an experiment the way y'all have been running an experiment. We decided to let our people be happy and free. And again, it's got the 98% recovery rate or whatever. So Florida's like, we kind of proved that these draconian measures and these lockdowns don't really work. Our economy, we kept our economy going. People are happy. They get in the sunshine. They're celebrating the Super Bowl. And they actually saw a decline in cases.
Dude, and it's so weird because they're all old. Florida's a sea of old people.
And you contrast the way Governor DeSantis handled it, considering that Florida has like 30% elderly population. That's where people go to retire. Shit, I love it so much. That's probably where I'm going to go.
I've never been.
Freezing.
Now I want to go.
Oh, man. Florida is amazing. And now more than ever.
Okay. So, shout out to the governor. Shout out to DeSantis, right? So you take him and then you take the coasts, who one is like the guy that did it best. No one's done it better than Cuomo.
Standard.
The gold standard.
The gold standard.
Who wrote a book and won an Emmy.
He was doing such a good job. He had time to take a time out. I'm gonna write a book during my amazing tenure as governor.
How crazy.
The gold standard. And then the reporter, I forget who it was, asked...
Kamala, right?
Jen Psaki.
Oh.
Asked Jen Psaki on TV, I believe it was ABC Network, one of them.
Okay.
They were like, so considering the Democrats done threw Cuomo under the bus, considering the FBI and everybody's looking into Cuomo... and how he tried to hide half of his numbers, his death numbers, which a big portion of America's, I guess, the death count for corona, for el virus, came from New York. Like, all this cover-up stuff going on. Meanwhile, Biden was saying, this is the gold standard. This is what we need to all be aspiring to be more like Cuomo in New York, not like DeSantis in Florida. So they asked Jen Psaki, so does this administration and the president, do they feel that Cuomo is still the gold standard? Yeah, she wanted to circle back real bad. She just tap danced around the ass. You know, we deal with a lot of governors and there's committees and stuff. And Cuomo's definitely somebody we still deal with because he's on this one committee. So we looking forward to improving. Okay. Does Biden feel that Cuomo did a good job and he's still the gold standard? Well, like I said, we deal with many governors and Jen, it's a yes or no question. Does he disavow or is he standing by? It doesn't have to be a yes or no question all the time. Damn, man. This is what you normies are getting. This is what y'all asked for. This is what y'all asked for. And I'm not trying to say, I can't save everybody. I'm just gonna give y'all a watered down Instagram page where I don't offend nobody. And you know what I'm saying? The little snowflakes and shit. Because y'all think Chingo Bling is crazy. Y'all think Trump is racist. Y'all think, you know, Rob ain't got no sense. I'm putting words in
there. I know, right? That's fine. That's fine. They see me, hear me. They're like, yeah, this guy doesn't know what he's talking about. Sounds white. Looks Mexican. Beard's too long. Might be a little Indian. I don't know.
A la madre.
Ah, pinche virus.
El virus.
So there's like half of the country, I think, has a Republican governor, I want to say. Close to half, if not over half. Mm-hmm. My thing is, what would it take and why haven't they all openly talked to the media, reacted to this virus the way that DeSantis has? Because he seems to have a really good grasp on it. He seems to make sense. That might be the title of this episode. Common sense, right? Mm-hmm. And yet, they don't. I don't know. I'm just throwing that out there. Like, if they did, I think the media couldn't avoid what's going on because you'd have over half the country that's like, hey, we're going to follow Florida's lead because these other motherfuckers are dumb, clearly.
Well, the media is too busy trying to vilify Governor DeSantis.
Yeah.
They're trying to vilify him. They're trying to come up with scandals. They're like, okay, there were these two counties in Florida that were mostly white, right? They got to throw that in. There were two counties in Florida that were mostly white, and Governor DeSantis decided to give them priority on these vaccines. How do y'all feel about it? And people, they asking people on the street, they're like, oh, that's kind of fucked up. You talking about it's mainly white people and this and that. Why should they get dibs? Well, DeSantis was like, first of all, we partnered up with Publix, the grocery store. These are, what did he say? Well, for one, they were trying to attack him because these are like affluent counties. He's like, okay, there are also lots of elderly in these counties. And he had his reasoning and it made a lot more sense than what Cuomo was doing, which is if you're elderly and you got el virus, we're going to send you back to the elderly folks' homes. And it's like, huh? What did he do? Oh, he was listening to the experts.
And you have a point. And just to go back to what I'm trying to get at, too, is that...
Why the other governors?
If the other governors just did what that fellow Republican does, or is doing, or has done, then the media... You can't find a scandal on over, you know, whatever, half the country governors. Like, you have to start covering that news, you would think, right? Like, that's real news.
And they'll twist the data, I'm sure.
I'm sure they will. They probably will. You're absolutely right. But also... Then people, the real fact checkers will go out there and say, well, no, that's not true at all. Over half the country is doing this way. We've done it the LA, New York way. We've done it that way. It don't work. Man, we know that much, right?
Pray for them.
We know at least that much, that it doesn't work. Okay, so instead of making these, what was that, a visual arts commercial in New York that de Blasio was doing, where they're dancing in the streets. Did you see that one?
Is it the dude rapping?
No, it was the dancer, where he's like, we got to bring arts back to New York City. We got to bring the light. You didn't see that video? Fuck, I should have queued it up. It's the most cringiest, dumbest video I've seen this year, and we're almost out of 2 months of the year already, so it's that speaks for itself. And then you got dummy over here in California, where they have...
Governor Puto Face?
Governor Puto Face.
Governor Puto Face.
Has found that at least half of the votes or of the, I guess, signatures to recall him could not be verified, and therefore, of the 1.5 million signatures, only about 600,000 of them were legitimate.
Oh, because he wanted to do signature verification.
Yeah, so therefore, they need about another 700,000 or 800,000 in order for the recall to actually work.
Oh.
And the deadline, I think, is March something.
Oh, what? California. Ooh.
Ooh. That's just dumb. Again, does that make
sense? So shouldn't we have signature verification for our presidential elections? No, Chingo, you're racist for saying that. People need to be able to mail in their stuff.
You fucking morons.
Man, look here, normies. You get what you deserve. You get what you voted for. Enjoy your lockdown. I'll pray for y'all's economy. And I know I'm Mr. They Can't Deport Us All. And I know my parents are immigrants. And I have an empathetic heart towards immigrants.
Absolutely.
However, some people have raised the point that the reason, they speculate, the reason that California's El Virus numbers are out of control is because of all the folks coming through.
Oh, yeah.
Coming through, working, leaving, or just coming through and doing, you know, they got the open border type of policy. And I mean, damn, we in a pandemic. Like, I get it. They can't deport us all. I get it. If you DACA and you educated and you've been living here and you're ready to contribute in a positive manner and you're not a troublemaker, yes, getting people their papers. But in a pandemic, I mean, damn, how bad stuff got to get for people to start being like, all right, look, everybody wants to come here. And we just can't have the door wide open. We at least need to be like, hey, man, what you here for? Where you coming from? What you got? What you got on you? I know nobody would allow their household to not have cameras and not have a lock on the door. You know what I'm saying? Not be like, shit, before you come stay at my house, where you coming from? What you got on you? What are your intentions? Who are you?
I'm circling way back to the beginning of the podcast when we're talking about Coca-Cola, because I just came to mind. There was a clip yesterday that Candace Owens had put up of a guest that she had on her podcast. I don't know if you listen to her show. I don't listen to it. I probably should listen to it. I like her. She's interesting.
And she
might run for president, even though a lot of people are like, hey, let's start a little smaller, maybe run for governor, mayor, something like that of somewhere. But either way, it's cool. Good for her. Mm-hmm. If AOC can get into, you know, if AOC, somebody who went to college and then bartended, and then now has say-so over your fucking life.
Yeah, she volunteered for the Bernie campaign.
Yeah.
And that's when she wet her whistle.
So when she's telling people that, you know, there was a video of her at a bar doing a speech, you know, with other bartenders there talking about the minimum wage, which we put it on the list, and I don't know how much we can really get into it because it's so convoluted, but she was saying no job that pays $2.15 an hour or whatever should be allowed. That's not a livable wage, whatever. Just all talking about this fight for 15, right? Mm-hmm. Well, for a bartender, you get tips. Mm-hmm. I like how they conveniently left that out. Mm-hmm. And if you're such a bad bartender server that you can't get enough tips to reach the minimum wage, they pay you the difference, whatever it gets you to the minimum wage. So that's just, again, they're playing with words here in a way that really tugs at the heartstrings. But it's just not true.
It's called the okey-doke.
Yeah. So aside from that, not really what I was getting at. The point here was the minimum wage. What did I say before that? I fucking lost my train of thought.
You said something about Coca-Cola.
Oh, the white people thing. Candace Owens. That's what I started at.
Yeah, Candace.
So she had this guy on, and we were talking about white people and black people, oppression, who's the most oppressed, all that stuff. And it never ends, right? So the point she was making to the guest was basically being more towards the attitude of let's hire people because they're qualified, right? This is the right person for the job. They should be doing it, not somebody because they're white, black, Mexican.
Not just because they're trans.
Yeah, not because they're anything, right? And his argument was consistently that, you know, he was a black guy, I forgot his name, that he looks at it as, do you know how hard that brother or sister had to work to get to this position of whatever, you know, they'll call it doctor, pilot. And her example was, if I get onto my plane and I see that the pilot is white, and I know that he was a better pilot, it can land and fly the plane better than anybody, no matter of their skin color, that makes me feel comfortable, safe, and happy. Mm-hmm. He goes, no, when I see a black pilot, I'm like, he had to work twice as hard to become that pilot.
She's That's what he said?
That's what he said. Like, what if he's not the best pilot to fly the plane, though? He's like, you don't understand. Like, he worked twice as hard to get to the pilot seat. I was like,
oh. Because they were holding him back from being a pilot?
Yeah, he was oppressed in all different angles that the white guy wouldn't have faced to become that pilot. Mm-hmm. And it's a lot of this 6-minute clip was a lot of that. And then in the middle of it, he's like, she asked him a question that kind of like threw his train of thought off, and he said, look, the United States, we're all so worried on this identity politics. I'm like, You just spent the first 4 minutes talking about why somebody who is oppressed should be in that pilot seat, for instance, or in the surgery office, mm-hmm. because they had more obstacles, allegedly, supposedly. And then he in the middle of it, kind of hits this roadblock. And it's like, look, we're all worried about identity politics. Like, that's around and around we go with everybody in that narrative.
Was he the BLM dude that she was, like, debating?
Was he? He may have been. He may have been.
Well, based on what he's saying, it doesn't sound like he's one of her, what's the word? You know, conservative on the right.
Oh, no, not at all. Yeah, no. Yeah, he was definitely a lefty of great proportions. I don't know. I just found that really frustrating.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to get on the affirmative action airlines.
And that's what they started talking about, affirmative action.
Yeah, can you imagine that shit that I'd be like, no way, el piloto es paisa, güey, pero sabes que, you know, he was failing, but they just kind of let him make it because they needed more brown pilots. I think really what it is, for example, my homie I went to middle school with, I think he went to the Air Force first, but now he's like a pilot, like a motherfucker. Dope. Pilot.
Cool.
And I think he does, if I'm not mistaken, he does a lot of stuff to encourage kids to like look into math and science and engineering and things like that, so that you're letting kids know they have the option of becoming a pilot. If you're not so worried about a sports scholarship or trying to be a rapper like Chingo Bling, you know, might have more engineers and pilots and shit like that. One thing I don't want to forget is there's a dude that was hired by CNN during the Trump administration. His main role was to be a fact checker. His name is Daniel Dell. So Daniel Dell, every time Trump would get on TV and be like, I have great approval in the black community, he'd be like, wait a minute, it's good, but it's not great, and it's not the best, therefore it's false. Even though Trump was just maybe using a certain language or hyperbole, mm-hmm. or just the, you know, positive spin or whatever. Fact check. Every chance he could, Daniel Dell was doing his job, which is to fact check. So what happens when Biden wins? Do you just fire Daniel Dell because now we don't need a fact checker? That would be too obvious. So he kept his job. He's still on salary. But the motherfucker been on TV one time since Biden went in. And what did he have to say? He was fact checking some shit Trump. Man, y'all some hoes, man.
Damn.
Bro, let me tell you about, I don't know, I don't even know who to blame no more. Y'all ain't had enough real homies in y'all's hood to where y'all too busy shooting each other and y'all not trying to get fucking Governor Newsom out of office. Y'all too busy being stupid on Instagram, getting offended over what I post, than to realize that CNN is fucking y'all, walking you straight off a cliff like a fucking crash dummy, and y'all just taking it. Y'all just on autopilot. Oh, Orange Man Bad is gone, and Biden's going to free the kids, and Biden's going to, you know, give amnesty, and Biden's going to open up the borders, and Biden's going to abolish ICE. Okay, cool. When this shit looking like Afghanistan,
God damn.
I mean, bro, you see how many fences they got around the fucking D.C.?
Mm-hmm.
That shit look like Iraq.
Yeah.
¿En qué cabeza cabe, güey? El pinche virus, they're saying we ain't finna be out of the virus for no Fauci and them talking about, no, you probably gonna need a third vaccine. Bill Gates talking about you're gonna need about 6 more masks. You're gonna have to, you still can't hug grandma. Christmas is still canceled. Ain't no concerts. Ain't nothing. This the new normal. Ain't no small business. Ain't no local bodega. Ain't no restaurant. Ain't no fucking entrepreneurs. Just wait on the state to have your kids in Zoom school and wait on your fucking, what is it? What is that? UBI.
Hmm.
Wait on your fucking UBI check from the government and wait on your FEMA and wait till the soldiers come and give you your vaccine and you still can't hug grandma. You still can't go to work. There's no reason why a 20-year-old who has no problem with this virus should not be able to. I mean, I guess now a lot of things are open.
Yeah, I'm starting to see more things come out about, like, we've reached a level of herd immunity. Mm. It's like, oh, how convenient, right?
Según.
But also, like, you know, like you said, 20-something, these kids in school, since apparently not until, like, more recently they said kids might be able to and have been contracting it. That was, like, way later in 2020 that was a thing. They need to be in school. They're going to fall so far behind. They've already basically lost an entire year.
A whole year.
Okay. And what I was telling them.
No PE, just depressed and shit, breathing in their own fucking breath all day.
And even if they go back to school, they won't, PE won't really be a thing. They'll have to have distance, at, you know, activities.
They can't kick it with their friends.
Can't kick it with their friends. The classes are going to be limited because half of them.
Talk shit at lunch.
Uh-huh. Can't talk shit anywhere because half of them are going to be home and half of them are going to be in class.
So now the teacher's trying to split her attention. His or her attention.
Exactly. So if you're having to teach both. One, the kids aren't socializing with their friends. They're not interacting. They're not being active. 50% of them are at home. So the teacher's spending half the time on the Zoom fucking kids and half the time on the kids in the class, which if you've seen some of these setups, you can't even see the board. If the board is right here, we'd have all these fucking, you know, little plexiglass rooms around us. I was already a bad student as it was.
Yeah. I already had ADD.
Yeah.
Much less trying to do school through a fucking laptop. I think this might be an issue where people on the left maybe kind of agree. Like, yeah, what's up with the kids, man?
I would hope
you
so.
Saw that whole school board had to resign.
Yeah.
Because they were like clowning the parents and shit. They just want their babysitters back.
They want to smoke weed at home.
The teachers' unions are keeping your kids' education hostage. And it's no coincidence that the teachers' unions are one of the biggest, what's the word? Like, they support the Democratic Party and this administration. So, if y'all stupid motherfuckers, if this shit don't get through to y'all, if this, what we're talking about right here, right now, that they are literally just ruining your kids. Your kids about to be dumb as a mug. Y'all kids, they leading your kids off a cliff. They not preparing them for nothing, for society. They just getting them ready for this new normal. They're being indoctrinated. And y'all too busy calling me a sellout coconut. Meanwhile, your kids ain't learning shit. This party y'all elected, or however went down, I don't know what happened, selected. This dude y'all got in there, man, he won't say within the first 100 days, kids going back to school. What happened? Do y'all not see this shit yet? Y'all don't see this shit yet? They just playing games with us, bro, off of this virus.
And, you know, that is, like, some of you also have to be concerned because you already know your kids were struggling to begin with, and this is only going to make it worse. Not taking any jabs at them, but...
They're going to make them dumber.
You know that your kids are struggling and already have a hard time learning. This is going to set them back so far for some. Anyway, the kids aren't going to school. They're not learning. They're going to push them ahead. My thoughts. So they're just going to push them ahead. And then you're even more quickly going to see how far behind they are. Because let's just say they go from fifth to sixth grade or fourth to fifth grade. And you miss that entire year. At this point, it's spring. They're still having spring break next week, right? So they're taking more time off. We're going to have... I don't even know what gen it is. Like, it's not Gen Z or X, whatever it is.
Generation dumb.
Generation dumb, who are, by design, get to a point where they're out of school if they get to it or if they just push them along enough. And then they're actually going to need handouts because they are so incapable of doing, providing. And that's just obviously, like, speaking in generalities. But might not be that bad. Might be worse. I don't know.
Well, parents, get your shit together. Start holding these politicians accountable, man. Like, if you're a teacher... Please leave a comment if you're watching on YouTube.
Oh, yeah, please do.
If you're a patron, let us know your experience. Maybe let us know your point of view, your perspective. Is there something we're missing? Is there, like, a lot of fake news on the right? Are they putting too much blame on the teachers' unions and it really ain't their fault? Please inform us and educate us as to what's really going on in different states, different school districts, to where the kids are suffering. And I'm starting to see now, even the mainstream media is starting to ask, who were they at? Was it Jen Psaki again? Were they like, hey, man, so what's up with the school? Oh, no, this is who it was. It was Kamala's press secretary. Mm. It's a lady with, like, a black lady with, like, her hair super short, like, hey, shaved.
We can't call her a lady.
Black lady.
We can't call her a black lady.
What is it? African American being?
Hey, we don't know what she identifies
person
as.
Person of color. Okay, we don't know. A black individual. That might chest feed. I don't know.
She might chest feed.
I don't know what kind of... Yeah, I don't know what's going on. But anyway, I believe it was Kamala's press secretary. Mm-hmm. Again, couldn't answer the yes or no question. They were like... It was mainstream. It was like ABC, Good Morning America. So a lot of the parents are concerned because these mainstream networks, although they love to lean left, this particular issue, and a lot of their viewers want answers. Hey man, when these kids going back to school? What the fuck is going on? And she's just like, well, this administration is making sure that the teachers are safe and da 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 da. And they're like, okay, so is Biden going to try to get the kids? What's the holdup?
She herself was on one of those morning shows. It was a video of her in like a really unflattering turtleneck.
Okay, that's the clip, I believe.
Uh-huh. Wasn't that Kamala?
Oh no, you're talking about Kamala? No, no, no.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
No. I'm talking about her.
Yeah, I'm talking about her. The one of her in the turtleneck.
And they were asking her questions about the school.
Yeah.
And they're like, what was hands?
She was just tiptoeing around it of like, we got to look at, you know, these numbers and, you know, we're working our way there kind of thing.
I mean,
it was an answer, non-answer. It just didn't make any sense.
Bro, somebody please help me understand this. What's the agenda? Is it another country with a hand up your ass like a fucking puppet just saying, we want those kids to be dumb. Those kids need to be dumb. Don't let them back. This is all part of the plan. New normal. Don't let them back because it's an economic war. I mean, America, bro, golly.
And the people at home too, like the parents that have the kids at home, how hard must it be to try to go to work or then also try to pay for some sort of child watch care at the same time during all this? Like you've been shot in both feet at this point.
Well, the rich people, guess what? Their kids ain't finna get left behind.
No.
The rich people?
No.
Private schools.
Yeah.
Tutors.
Tutors, whatever the homeschool. There's another term for homeschooling. I forgot what it is, but.
Nah. People with bread, bro, their kids ain't finna get left behind.
Mm-mm.
The normies out there, they like Governor Puto Face and. Y'all too busy. All you motherfuckers too busy calling me a coconut and a sellout and a race traitor and all these stupid basic ass elementary ass. Go sit at the kids' table and enjoy what you wanted. This is what you wanted. This is what you deserve. Your kids gonna be dumb. They giving you the runaround. They can't tell you when the fuck the world's gonna open back up. And yeah, I sound frustrated because I'm not even allowed to talk about the shit. I gotta go on to my side Instagram page to really say what the fuck I really want to say in America.
And I think people will find that the sentiment here in this episode and in the entire series and in the podcast and everything that we talk about is that we really do want the best for everyone, right? All we're saying is hashtag common sense, hashtag TIA believes in common sense, is we want prosperity for all. We want everybody to be educated. We want everybody to have an equal opportunity at doing the best they can, obtaining the most that they can. And without all these handouts, right? Mm-hmm. And meanwhile, here, you know, Chingo might talk with some in a spirited way, and it's deemed, you know, you're a crusader for this nonsense on the right. If we just stop looking at right or left and just look at common sense, I think you'll see that the common sense tends to fall one way more than the other. I don't know why, but it just does. And if you disagree, I think you're dumb.
Look, I'm about to put a story on my my real Chingo Bling page, and I want y'all to hear what the fuck I'm about to say. What it do, y'all? Welcome to my real Chingo Bling Instagram. This really ain't my real Instagram because I can't even say what I want to say. So follow me on the What Did He Said page. That's where I really get to let loose and talk shit. In the meantime, all you normies, enjoy what you deserve. Your kids still ain't back in school. These people can't give you straight answers to when the fucking world gonna open back up. You don't know when your business gonna open back up. You don't know where the STEMI at. You don't know what the fuck's going on because they can't give you straight answers. I'm starting to think y'all like being lied to because y'all are simple-minded, man. And they fucking over your kids. Your kids ain't even in school yet. They're in Zoom school. They ain't got no PE. They breathing in their own breath all day. So you know what? Fuck this Instagram page. Follow me on the other one. Because right here, I ain't even got freedom of speech. Y'all too goddamn sensitive, man. Y'all too sensitive. Y'all being little snowflakes. Y'all love getting triggered. Y'all over there, y'all got puto faces for governors and shit. Killing old people. I don't know what the fuck's going on. So like there, cut me off.
Oh, listeners, how much do you want to bet by the time that this podcast airs, we're gonna find that Chingo's stories were taken down for hate speech and taken down for virus, false claims?
Man, yeah, no. Go,
no,
go.
No, make sure you tag the What Did He Said page.
I am. I'm doing that right now.
On all of the stories.
And I hope y'all hear my frustration because it's true. Like, people telling me I need to, like, why have there not been any more post that could be interpreted as political or whatever on my Facebook and on my Instagram is because I've already been told and instructed that maybe people think it's weird or you look a little obsessed or you're dividing your fan base. Man, you're supposed to be a fucking adult. You're supposed to be like George Lopez and them can run their mouth about what the fuck they think. Nobody's holding them accountable. Sorry, I don't want to bring up George Lopez. They're going to think I'm trying to be competitive because we're both Mexican and we're both Mexican-American. We both do comedy. So, George, I'll take it back. thank you for your contribution. Thank you for all the Latino comedians you've helped throughout your career. Let's use somebody else as an example. Let's just say pick your mainstream Latino celebrity that was vouching for Joe Biden. I mean, massaging is nuts. Oh, Señor Biden, si tienes frío, wey, te la sobo, wey. Oh, yeah, Señor Biden, we need Biden. Still, ain't no STEMI. Your kids still ain't in school. We need to make, like, a list. I might have, like, a screenshot, but we need, like, a little concise list of, like, just to be able to say, like, okay, here's an update. You still ain't got this. They still ain't gave you that. You still waiting on this.
Yeah, I like how people's arguments on the comments will be like, why are you so worried about the STEMI, right? And, take that sentence that was just typed by all these, you know, keyboard warriors, mm-hmm. and think about the people that did vote with enthusiasm for this gentleman and this party in hopes of, and there's a compilation of this video, if you vote so-and-so, vote the Reverend in and vote Warnock in, and you'll get the $2,000, you know, dollars the next day. A lot of people were banking on that STEMI. We're banking on the 2 G's.
I just want to be able to get back to work. I don't need no STEMI.
No, exactly, but that's what I'm saying. Like, it's not, you're not actually concerned about the STEMI.
My thing is this: we don't want loans. We don't want STEMIs. I think most people just want to be able to get back to work. If you let people get back to work, they're gonna be like, I don't need none of that shit.
America.
Look, somebody posted. This was a while. They posted this on Valentine's. It said, "So far, the lesser evil quote allowed 11 million immigrants in." Again, you know, I'm very biased when it comes to immigrants, so I'm just reading what he put. Allowed 11 million immigrants in, gave 4 billion to immigrants. I don't know what he means by that. Mm. Wants to take your guns. Mm-hmm. Fine you $150,000 and jail you for 25 years for said guns. Has yet to send STEMIs. Double mask, right? That's a whole nother subject. Lockdowns until 2022. Tax on holding stocks. Y'all happy yet? And there's probably like a whole bunch of other bad stuff that they are doing. Like I saw another one that was like gave this country this Raytheon missiles and gave this country, that country millions for this and that. And let me see. Okay. I'm trying to find it.
Chingo's got a database where he goes to. And he's like, I've collected these thoughts. I have the information. And all I'm trying to do is just share the information. And all people want to do is give him a hard-ass time for thinking out loud, basically.
Yeah, and I don't want to jeopardize my tour or my business or whatever to further tarnish my brand. I've always been outspoken. This shit shouldn't even surprise y'all. I'm 41. If I was still thinking the way I did when I was 21... I'd be concerned.
That'd be a problem, yeah.
Yeah, there's a quote in the Bible that's like I'm paraphrasing. It's like, when I was a child, I thought like a child, I spoke like a child, but as a man, you know what I'm saying?
That's a good one.
It's in Corinthians. Anyway, go on, Rob.
That sounds like a Tony Robbins quote, but I like it.
Here it is. 85 million Raytheon arms deal for Chile, 197 million Raytheon missiles for Egypt, 245 million Raytheon arms deal US, I don't know what that means, 1.2 billion Raytheon missile defense in talks, zero stimulus checks, drone strikes in Somalia, built a new US military base in Syria, sent thousands of troops to Yemen, Syria, Iraq, froze price decrease plan on the insulin, froze price decrease plan on the EpiPens, canceled the Keystone XL pipeline, killed thousands of jobs, refunded the Wuhan Institute of Virology, and sent the World Health Organization $200 million. And you got a pussy ass governor, so you deserve all that shit. Because you on my page talking shit about me. So guess what? Look, as soon as this Patreon pops off,
the amount of content.
Todos me la pelan.
We're going to make commercials and billboards. We're gonna take it like the Steve-O route and just put billboards up in cities and be like, you dummies, you played yourself. Something ridiculous.
Like I said, man, we just need to compile that list and just remind these motherfuckers. And y'all heard what I had to just say on my main, is my quote-unquote main Instagram. How boring is that, man? You can't even say what you want to say. How lame is that? That you self-suppressing your own voice just because you sound a little too passionate. Just, all right then, well, fuck it.
You sound like you care. Let's go back to the previous episode when you were like, I'm just going to stop giving a fuck.
I'm just going to smoke a lot of weed and let you crash dummies walk off a cliff and let these fucking Latino celebrities, oh my God, Mr. But we need Biden. Oh my God, I cried. I wore my Chucks and my pearls. Oh my God. Oh my God. Finally, normalcy. Oh my God. Finally. Finally, we have a good president. Pendejos.
If you don't think that the
pinches estúpidos la cagaron.
A part of the American way is to talk as much absolute shit about everything that goes on. That is the American way.
Not anymore.
All right. You point things out. All right. You call it how it is. And people, like, there's a reason that when DeSantis is giving a presser or whatever, even when he's being attacked by some of these, which we've played some videos in the past where the journalist is like, why is it that, you know, like the vaccine rollout is like, and she tries to ask a second and third. He's like, whoa, let me answer that. I've already answered that question, you know, like, and he gives a really good answer. Basically, everybody that's ever asked him something that I've seen, I'm sure there's ones that
he
owns the shit out of him, right? So people are clapping too. Like if you hear, people are like,
he's saying absolute real shit.
For real. Keep in mind also, half of, maybe more, of the country voted in his direction, right? When this, like you're saying, when this Patreon pops off, people are going to be, they're fiending for shit talking like this and truth like this. And then, you know, inevitably tell friends like, hey, you know those platforms where people are having to suppress what they actually think? And when you disagree with them and try to say something about it, you're you know, mysteriously banned, or your comments disappear because Instagram doesn't like it or whatever. Those are all necessary evils. Don't get me wrong. These platforms help us do shit, but they really, really put you back against the wall.
Yeah.
When the Patreon pops off, or any private portal, forum, membership site, whatever that we come up with in the future, people are going to be so, it's going to be like so refreshing that you can actually hear what's going on based off of an honest thought and common sense.
Mm-hmm. Well, look,
it's going to take some time.
As soon as, I mean, God willing. And you know what might, unfortunately, push people towards keeping an open mind? When this man sends us to war, which is just a matter of time.
Yeah.
When motherfucking war pops off, it's going to be time to remind them, hey, we have 4 years of no new wars. Because I mentioned that when I was on that podcast with American Cholo, I was like, well, 4 years, no new wars. He was like, Chingo, how you gonna say that? Because we've been at war. We've been in perpetual war. It was back in the 80s and this, and we still ain't pulled troops out of here, and we still got bases over here. I'm like, bro, I said no new wars.
Yeah.
New. Yeah. What part of new? You ain't hear that part?
Yeah.
You just want to hear what you want to hear.
For sure.
So when this man or woman sends us to war, am I still a sellout? Am I still the coconut? And you still ain't got no stimmy? You still can't go to work? Boy, I swear to God, y'all slow, bro. All the patrons that are listening, I'm not talking to you. That's the part you need to play for these slow motherfuckers. Be like, man, listen to Chingo, man. Chingo be breaking it down. He gave you that trill shit, that trill spill, that real spit. Motherfucking unadulterated. Fuck his Instagram. He ain't even being himself on there because he can't.
You got to go to a live show to see the real Chingo, and you got to sign up for the Patreon to see the real Chingo.
Yeah, no, I mean, again, I shouted out the tour dates. We have a handful, and we have another little handful. We're trying to see if it's going to happen. But goddamn, I can only do Texas and Florida, but so much. The rest of y'all need to catch the fuck up. Catch the fuck up. Open up. Let these people get back to work.
At this rate, though, they are saying that about 60%, I think, of businesses will close by September and probably not reopen.
Yeah, all by design.
All by design.
And guess what? Amazon got rich.
Yeah. A lot of these, you know, big box companies got Costco, you know.
The rich got rich.
They did.
That's what y'all wanted.
And you should really go back. I know there was an extended teaser that I put up for the Chris Irons episode. Mm-hmm. if at the very least you want to sign up and cancel because there's no member, like there's no, you're not locked into anything. You could just sign up for the $5 and listen to the full Chris Irons episode and then have takeaways and then cancel if you want. And then maybe go sign up for Chris Irons' Quoth the Raven Patreon. Just hop on, listen to that, and see what kind of ideas are stimulated about what you're doing with your attention to your money, future money, the route of investments maybe.
I love that episode.
It was really good, man. He motherfucker can talk, and he knows what he's talking about.
I learned so much. I took so many notes. I'm gonna go back listen again.
And the people in his circle of economists and financial people, like Rebel Capitalist, is a fantastic podcast and show. We didn't even touch on it with him, but these people that are going out there and investing in crisis countries, you know, and then learning about what this is, and then kind of likening it to how people here in our country are taking it. Like, what is it? No tragedy will go.
No crisis gone to waste.
No crisis gone to waste. And if you don't think that a lot of people are raving about the fact that so many small businesses are going under, because then they get to capitalize on it on their end. And then you have, again, the $15 minimum wage, we might save that for another episode or get somebody that's a real expert on that. That's going to kill a lot of small businesses. And you'll have AOC and Bernie. And that's why I brought up that bar video earlier talking about how you need to raise a minimum wage. It ain't that simple.
Well, Bernie couldn't even keep his $15 when he was campaigning.
He fired a couple people, didn't he?
Yeah, he was like, man, I can't do it.
Yeah, it's
Bernie, so look, dumb. Man. Look, man. I respect Bernie in a lot of ways, but at the same time, I don't think Bernie's ever had to run a business or have employees. He's just been a politician.
And that's what I get at with AOC, too,
He's been a politician his whole life. Sure, he's had the same stance, you know, America, social, everybody, healthcare, that's cool. But you've literally just been a politician. So you just been, somehow he got millions of dollars. He got a couple milli.
He's sucking on the taxpayers' teat, you know, all these years. Saint Biden is going into his 48th, right, year,
man, as a politician. Hey, man, don't you talk about the man everybody voted for.
Pinche pobrecito.
You know, we should do a Spanish episode because... You know,
we do get that a lot. I see that a lot.
You've seen that?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Maybe as we're trying to add programming to our lineup for the week so that there's something dropping damn near every day, maybe even if it's short, we should do a Spanish one because not only is that great practice communicating in Spanish, porque yo me tartamudeo, güey.
Oh, dude.
When I be around like straight paisas, it's like my Spanish is, my brain fries up.
Visité mi mamá yesterday. See, I can't even do it. Like, I'll go into this, and I used to make fun of people that were like super Spanglish and shit. I'm like, why is my Spanish breaking down? It's because I don't hang out with any of my... Yeah. That'd be good. That'd be good practice. La práctica.
No, and not only that, but to red pill the raza, because... The raza might get it more than some of you normies, bro.
They probably would because they come from some of these places where they're like, "This wait. If you break it down to me, you're saying what now?"
Man, look, you know, Luisa, our babysitter, she got a whole bunch of grandkids, right?
I saw you were partying. I saw that meat on the grill.
Those are practically Penny's little cousins because they're just grown up together. Mm-hmm. They're all little babies growing up together. So there's always a birthday party over there. We were over there a couple days ago, right when the freeze ended. And we're out there chit-chatting and comparing stories. Oh, ¿cómo les fue? No, que, you know, no, perdimos la luz y, you know, la chimenea, que la chingada. And we get to talking, and there's always one that's like, no, pues ya ves el T. Cruz se fue para Cancún, güey. Pues no, pues qué es eso, hombre. And then I'm trying to explain ERCOT and shit in Spanish and the power grid and how the stuff that Chris Irons was explaining. I was giving them the thing, I was like, look, si se fue la luz, you know, alguien la cagó, like, sure, it was bad. I was like, but what we don't want to do is let the government be in charge. I was like, how is it in Mexico when your lights go out? They're like, nah, it's just one light company. So what is it with your phone? It's one phone company. He's like, es un pelado. Like, it's one motherfucker. You know, what about your gas? Pemex, that's it. It's all like nationalized and privatized. I think that's the word. I don't know what the proper terminology, but I was like, is that what you want? Where everybody's on one grid and there's no free market competition to where, hey man, Reliant and NRG, whatever, you know, all these different companies, who is it, CenterPoint? Is that gas?
No, they do both, gas and electric.
So I guess the way the Texas grid is set up, you know, you got that free market competition and then there's a fluctuate the rates and there's incentives. Like the shit Chris was talking about. Mm-hmm. You have to incentivize these companies to do what you want them to do, you know, stuff like that. And I mean, shit, California, they got brownouts all the time. It ain't got to be, you know, it ain't got to be like, well, it was a 122 year freeze.
Man, I just suddenly got kind of excited at the thought of
the Spanish.
The Spanish,
like, we got a red pill de raza, bro.
You think
bro?
We could really, like, you think we could get our ideas down so tight
that Dio,
we could?
Tio Juventino need to do that shit. Hey, wait.
No, Taco Carlson.
Oh, see, sí, el Taco Carlson.
Taco Carlson.
Alias el Taco Carlson.
Like, we could, it probably wouldn't be, like, right now we're going on an hour and a half, over an hour and a half. I don't know if we could do an hour and a half in Spanish, but we could probably do half an hour, might do a full hour.
Yeah, poco a poco, yeah, know, to start getting our tongue, you know what I'm saying? Like,
acostumbrados.
See, you know, to communicate, man.
It's important because, but there is something to say that when it comes to the population that's a little bit older, you know, the people that were paisa before paisa was popping, as you would say, they may be reluctant, but they also may take some time to, like, hop on or peep game.
Well, I mean, go ahead.
But it's totally worth the attempt. I mean,
I'll put it to you like this, bro. I feel like you have a better chance. Yeah. With a paisa than with a Chicano.
You are absolutely right.
The Chicanos have been indoctrinated. The Chicanos, they watch mainstream media. They consume all that Hollywood stuff. They looking at what America Ferrera posted on Instagram, how she's crying over Kamala. They're buying the narrative of racism and white supremacy, and they want to be involved. So they want to go out there with BLM and Antifa. And
do you know what Chicano studies is?
Please break that shit down.
No. I honestly just kind of caught wind of that term.
Is it
based? I don't know.
Okay.
So maybe we can touch on that on another episode.
I think Eva Longoria got a minor or a major in Chicano studies.
Really? Okay. I was just curious. If y'all know, please educate.
Yeah, please let us know. Send us a message. Leave a comment. Chime in. Educate us. Chicano studies, I don't know. But to me, it sounds like a whole bunch of reading about civil rights type stuff. Okay. Maybe some brown beret type of movement. It's almost like the equivalent of, you know, you got the Black Panthers, you got the brown berets. You know, you got your Stokely Carmichaels and your Martin Luther Kings and all these people. And then you got like your Cesar Chavez, mm-hmm. who was against immigration. So that's kind of a doozy. So is that our Harriet Tubman? Like, are they going to put him on a dollar? I wouldn't put it past Biden. They're smart. They know how to do symbolic shit. For the normies, like they, you know, they gave black folk, we're gonna put Harriet Tubman, we're gonna yank that white man off the fucking dollar, you know, you passed up on the platinum plan, the $500 billion that Trump was offering, but we're gonna yank Andrew Jackson, racist ass, white ass off the 20, and we're gonna put Harriet B. Tubman on the twenty. And now the minute Raza starts saying, hey, what about us? The minute we start to complain too much, hey, give me the dollar bill. Take George White. We're putting Cesar Chavez on there. And Raza going to be, oh, yes, thank you. Thank you, Kamala.
Meanwhile, people that are actually coming from other countries are like,
they'll be like, they did that in my country too. Like,
and now here I am over here.
Yeah, exactly. So I know last time I mentioned Chile, but Chile right now, they got some shit going down with like the indigenous people. And then you got your like more European, basically the white people over there, the settlers that came, they either like stole some land, bought some land, were given some land. So there's always been that strife. Chile has an interesting past. I'm not an expert on it. But current day, there's a lot of propaganda. There's a lot of like Antifa type shit going down, almost like some BLM type stuff, but it's like indigenous. And they're spray painting ACAB, all cops are bastards on the walls. And the media is making the cops look like the bad guys because they did some shit, had to defend themselves, and an indigenous person got shot. So it's just a playbook. It's just a little blueprint. And, you know, even if I'm wrong, we should be mature enough to discuss it and have the ideas go at it instead of a motherfucker having to self-suppress and can't even be himself and shit. So follow me on the What Did He Said Instagram.
Yeah, the podcasting also is like the last frontier of what...
Oh, they coming for that next.
They're coming for it. You know, it might take a while. I think that'll take it'll be a long time.
They're laying the groundwork, though. Yeah. What they're going to do is, they already started. They said, I forget who, it might have been at NPR. They did a little report saying, here's an example of a neo-Nazi who has a podcast. Should Apple Podcasts have a little bit more stringent controls? And should this person be allowed up next on The Daily? Dun, 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 New York Times.
Yeah.
So they're laying the groundwork. They're letting you know there's crazy people that have podcasts, Rob. And this is very dangerous for our democracy. They're spreading lies and conspiracies, Rob, like the big lie. Some people that on podcasts believe that Biden really didn't win. And da, 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 da. They'll kick them off first. That'll be like the Alex Jones of podcasts. And then they'll deplatform somebody else. They already on Joe Rogan's ass. Except he's Teflon. He's just like, bitch, whatever, jujitsu.
It's gonna, you know, it's gonna get to the point where more people than you ever would have thought are gonna find it important to find out who's on AWS, the Amazon Web Services. How do I go about building my own infrastructure? And if it's not to like build a platform that was like Parler, that literally, it, like we said a long time ago, if Microsoft was never able to do it. They never built the infrastructure to build something like a Parler for themselves, a whole huge, you know, platform. They could at least find a way to like Tom Green it or Alex Jones it or the No Agenda, Adam Curry, who like the godfather of podcasting, like created the RSS feed and created the syndication of what we're doing right now. I think they have their own servers. A lot of people are going to end up going to that route where they're going to have to fund it one way or another. If you have a message or need a platform, you're going to have to create your own.
And then maybe at that point, people will realize, oh,
we fucked up.
All that freedom of speech stuff Chingo was talking about. Because they've literally, once they kick everybody off, once they Coca-Cola your ass, and you're not allowed to be white, you're not allowed to ask questions, you're not allowed about, you're not allowed to question certain data or bring up any questions like, hey, what's up with the flu numbers? You know what I mean? Like, once they deplatform everybody, silence everybody, and it's just Twitter's just an echo chamber for people on the left and everybody on YouTube, you know what I'm saying? Maybe then people will be like, we don't feel that free anymore. It's almost like you really can't go against the grain. It's almost like that social credit score where, we saw you tweet it's a weird meme, Gina Carano. You know what I'm saying? Gina Carano, bam, Disney kicked her off. And people don't even understand what that was about. People were just, the normies that are just going, they're just like, oh yeah, she said mean stuff about Jews anyway. And it's like, no, she said, she the meme was an analogy comparison of like, basically the left are acting like Nazis and they're persecuting the right. They're persecuting Trump supporters and conservatives or Republicans, just like they did Amanda Ensing with the Sephora thing. They tried to cancel her, just like they did Goya.
And she made a really good point of how the Nazis had, you know, they made their neighbors turn on themselves, right? Mm-hmm. The people turned on the people.
We're on the snitching era.
Yeah, yeah. And Tim Dillon does a really good running bit of how everybody's a rat these days, you know? And that she never likened the two things, like conservatives or right-leaning people to people that were in concentration camps or any of that. All that stuff was, it became super convoluted and conflated and people were just, didn't know what the fuck was going on. They just read the title and was like, fucking cancel her, right? And I think she was on Ben Shapiro's show. She did a full, I haven't watched it yet, but I'm just interested. Either. You haven't watched it? I'm just interested in her own words, like how that all kind of transpires and what she makes of it. Because her co-star, right?
Pedro.
He has his history of, you know, tweeting some really crazy shit that he also just had completely wrong.
So he did Nazi analogies, and I guess it was cool then.
Yeah.
Because he was calling basically America and Trump people and conservatives Nazis, basically.
And then you had the last 4 years, which we can't, how could we forget, you know, Trump's a Nazi, the whole thing. How is that? That was just okay.
They've been spitting that shit for 4 years straight, 5 years straight. And people bought it. People bought it. I bought it. I believed. I was like, man, he did say the thing about Mexicans. And I mean, everywhere I look, everyone's saying he's the bad guy. Until I started realizing, like, wait, he really didn't say that shit. He didn't say drink bleach.
Damn, it's tough.
However, Joe Biden did say that Latinos and blacks don't know how to use computers. Arguably, he didn't mean that. Maybe that's fake news. Maybe we should have more context on that. But why should you get the benefit of the doubt if y'all ain't get this other man benefit of the doubt? Why should I be out here campaigning? Man, look, see how fake news is? Y'all see how it works? No. I'm gonna let you walk off that cliff with all them other Latino celebrities that was like, Biden. Che idiotas.
Stupid.
Che gente estúpida.
Good shit. I like how, like, today I forgot to, or I left that my place without printing out our outline. All we had to do was write 3 bullet points down, and we could just do two hours like that.
Yeah, because
professional.
It's so much going on.
That too.
And so much stuff I'm not allowed to talk about on my Instagram because people will get offended, and I might look a little too passionate about America and freedom of speech, and we don't want that. We just want little old Chingo to just post lame, generic, watered-down fucking memes. That's what y'all have marginalized me to just, motherfucker, go be funny. Go do a little TikTok. And it's like, all right, if I make fun of your boy Biden, are you going to cry? Or I just got to keep that shit on my TikTok.
The ghetto of fucking the platforms.
Cry baby ass motherfuckers. Yeah, boy, y'all ain't shit. I swear to God.
Well, if people want to laugh and see live, Chingo, let's remind them again where you're going to be, maybe. Because I do actually want to know.
Okay. Yeah. What do you want to know?
Where you going to be?
Yeah. Man? San Angelo, Texas, March 13th. Mission, Texas, March 26th. New Braunfels, Texas, April 3rd. Brea, California, we hope, April 7th. Killeen, Texas, April 9th and April 10th. Por favor, believe it.
Falsely claim he lied about two. They falsely claim that he lied. No, Joe Biden lied. And you want to see him lie? Here it is.
If you send John and the Reverend to Washington, those $2,000 checks will go out the door.
We will be able to pass $2,000 stimulus checks for the people next week.
We'll deliver the $2,000 stimulus checks, and that begins with the $2,000.
Dude, that's the one I was referencing earlier.
Me and Reverend Warnock to the Senate, we will pass those $2,000 stimulus checks. You send me and Reverend Warnock to the Senate, we will pass those $2,000 stimulus checks.
Man, y'all some lying assholes.
That dude, I mean, they both annoy me. And it's not because of Democrats. It's just because, you know, you just kind of get this ick feeling about, you know, certain people. And the Reverend, he had some fucking crazy shit in his history based off of what his, I guess, ex-wife or whatever said.
Estoy meando, güey.
Okay, okay. And then the fucking, the other guy, Ossoff, is like a filmmaker and shit.
I'm about to take a piss break.
Oh, man. All right, just wrap it up. You'll wrap it up.
Oh, that is the end of the show. Thank you so much, all the patrons. Patreon.com/RedPillTamales. My little bladder is really little. I got to go back.
Don't trip.
All right, guys, we are back. You know, I had to run, use a potty real quick. That was a false alarm. That was not.
That was not.
Well, the P wasn't false.
Oh, okay, okay.
Ending the show was false.
It was.
We had to go in and make some bacon and egg tacos.
Delicious.
I even got a little Greek yogurt dessert. I put some diced pineapple on top like a thug.
I noticed that. I saw that. I was like, I should have actually done a story. I was like, who else gets, you know, this type of this great chef experience from Chingo Bling personalized? Well,
normally, I hook up the granola way more than that. I mean, the yogurt. It usually has some granola in that bitch.
That's true. You'll put the granola and the berries. And this time you got pineapple. You got real fancy this time.
Yeah, I just put the little canned diced pineapples. So nothing, you know, I don't want to trigger nobody. You know, I start getting called a sellout.
Yeah, well, fruit's so triggering and all.
Orale, hey, that's white people shit. Eating fruit. Watching your protein intake. Hey, that's white people shit. Stop being so white. Be less white, like Coca-Cola said.
Yeah, right. That's why I moved my can, because Chingo's out of fucking HEB Coke Zero. What?
The lady that did the speech at Coca-Cola, is she white or black? What is, the lady that was on with Jimmy?
Robin? Yeah. D'Angelo? She looks white,
right? She looked pretty white to me.
Can you be a white person that's... I mean, I guess so. You couldn't have a... I mean, I guess you could, but you don't want to have a black person that says all white people are racist, because that's pretty racist.
I mean, I was assuming that it was a black woman that wrote the book and a black woman that's getting paid to go to Coca-Cola.
Oh, no, you want to have the white woman who's like virtue signaling to this, you know, to this audience that's saying that my people, like, we're all racist. Like, we're...
Well, didn't they say there's like 8 types of white people now?
Oh,
it's like, it's like shades. It's almost like on one end of the spectrum... It's see, this is the kind of stuff I try to explain to my 12-year-old. She's just like, what? I was like, I know, right? It sounds crazy, doesn't it?
It doesn't get any easier to understand when you get older either.
They're literally saying there's 8 types of white people. It goes from one end of the spectrum is like white abolitionists, meaning they're pretty much woke social justice warriors. They know that they're inherently part of the problem. They know that they have to be less white. You know, basically, they go along with what they're being told.
Right.
And then on the other end is like your... you're, you know, extreme, I don't know, like hella white, like you just extra white, like you just can't dance for shit, you know, just all the stereotypes.
I used to hate Charlemagne saying shit like
mayonnaise.
Yeah, yeah, that term was, it was just like, he could just, and hit, you know, the Breakfast Club's like a huge syndicated show, and you're just saying shit like that all willy-nilly, like, hey, so mayonnaise, and, you know, plain, I guess, what is it, just like plain, like lame, plain lame, white mayonnaise shit? Is that
I guess white people like mayonnaise a lot, and that's his slang.
Yeah.
I mean, he is a shock jock.
Oh, yeah, to the max.
So that's already kind of his...
shtick.
Yeah, it's already kind of his lane.
Yeah.
But if I'm not mistaken, I had to tune out.
Totally.
I don't really listen to it.
Yeah.
It's just Hot 97 and that whole show, they're just so left with it. I don't expect them to be like country-loving, patriot, gun-toting, Bible-thumping, like, hey, this is Charlemagne the God. You know, yeah. Welcome back. We're calling out the lefties. I don't expect that. But I mean, I think they were like worshiping Biden on one. Like, I think, what's her name? Angela Yee. She was like, you know, it was just so good to see, you know, she's a, you know, this female, and she's a South Asian, you know, Indian, and, you know, and Caribbean. And because I think Angela Yee's mixed kind of like that somehow. And, you know, it was just so refreshing. And I'm like, oh, man, get off the boo-boo.
Earlier when I mentioned the Jennifer Aniston picture that led to that other picture, it also, when I kept scrolling, led me to another Jennifer Aniston fucking thing where it was the clip. I think it was a guy, it was maybe Good Morning America or some shit. But remember the black guy, the black anchor reporter guy that was like, and I got to, you know, he's crying on TV and tell my son, I forgot what the fuck it was. But it's just like, it was so forced. Like a lot of these lefties, I don't know what the fuck to call them anymore, that are like crying at the podiums and crying on TV about some of this stuff. It's so bad. Like you should have taken a class or two of improv or something before you try to fake cry on national television.
I saw that. was it Van Jones?
Was it? I don't know.
A black dude on CNN?
Maybe, yeah.
We're not talking about Don Sweet Tea Lemon.
No.
Let me see. This man, I'm about to block your pussy ass. These people on here.
It was Van Jones.
Cry baby. I'm looking at these comments on my Instagram.
Yeah.
People are so triggered, man. Just like we said earlier, like I can't post shit. So I posted this meme during the freeze. It got like 2,000 likes, 150 comments. The meme was the dude with his belly out, photoshopped into a like the Oval Office where Biden is. He's like, oiga, you know that cheque por la nieve? Like, hey, do we get a stimmy for this freeze?
Right.
And my caption was, fools in Texas want to know. And of course, all these comments, like, you need to ask Ted Cruz. Where's Ted Cruz? And your Republican governors and blah, 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 blah. It's like, y'all don't even understand what happened.
You should have just said, he went to Cancun to lasso the sun, bring it back.
Yeah, but it's like, look at this. What's up in Texas? Look like the governor is slipping. Shut the fuck up. Look at this one. Ask the Republicans you worship so much. He's actually sending help while your boy Ted Cruz tried to hide in Mexico. What has Abbott or Cruz done yet besides point fingers?
Send help. We didn't even cover this, actually. The talk about him, Governor Abbott, requesting aid and Biden basically like declining. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Watch my reply to this person that says, I worship Republicans. Cállate el hocico mejor, güey. Ahí está. All right, sorry, I had to reply.
No, no. Do you know what I'm talking about, though?
What did Biden say? He's not going to send no aid?
Yeah, it was it was something that Governor Abbott had requested, I think, weeks in advance, like knowing that the storm could potentially be like catastrophic like this. I'm paraphrasing here. He was requesting, I think, something about like, alleviating some of the green rules to allow Texas to ramp up some energy production. And basically, like, Biden's, they said no, like, you can't. And then we got hit with the storm, and it was worse than, it was as bad as I guess they had thought. I don't know. Point is, they leaked, but they just posted the papers. It's like, you know, Governor Abbott to President Biden. It was just like on the letterhead of like the presidential shit or government stuff. Requesting this, and then them being like, nah, we're cool, we're good, you don't get that, you don't get that aid, or you don't get that, you know, alleviation of green rules to produce more energy or some shit.
Am I allowed to say FJB?
I mean, why not? FJB.
Look at this comment right here. The trumpets that got caught at the Capitol got played by Trump, just like Texas is getting played by Ted Cruz. Good job, guys. I'm telling you guys, they don't really care about y'all. What? The trumpets that got caught at the Capitol got played by Trump, just like Texas getting played by Ted Cruz. Shut the fuck up.
Blow to Ted Cruz. He's like, I just wanted to be a good dad while simultaneously, which again, I'm not defending what he did. It was dumb. You probably could have sent somebody to take the kids and the wife, like, I don't know, fucking friend or servant or a secret service person. I don't know. I'm just making shit up here. He probably has somebody that, whoever was watching his dog, he probably had somebody else that could have watched his family go to Cancun.
All they know, this is what it is. They know this man might try to run for president again. And they just trying to like throw as many. I mean, you know, like I said on the last episode, he walked right into that one. I don't know what he was thinking, because he should have known. Like, man, I bet you anything AOC punk ass gonna come down here and pass out a couple water bottles and give a speech and hop back on the plane and make me look stupid. And that's exactly what happened.
Yeah, we have to want more from these people, right? These public servants. And I think Ben Shapiro was talking about it a couple of days ago, where this whole thing of like half of the optics or whatever phrase you want to use of a politician is being at this place where something happens. And that's great. That's fine. Like, I think that's good. You should show up and help if you can. But if they don't, or if they can't, or if they decide to go elsewhere, their entire reputation shouldn't be tarnished because he didn't show up to what? Again, put on his utility belt and start helping people, like, put power back on? Or just because AOC decided to come and do the photo opt and stand in line and put a couple cans in a box? She's not a better congresswoman. She's not a better person. Well, my point is, like, you have to care about other things. Like, you can't just care about that stuff. Like, there's no way that I refuse to believe that the majority of America, because I love people, but man, y'all are proving me wrong. Like, y'all are some people are really dumb. They only care about that surface level stuff. And it's as if everything below that, which is more important, isn't happening or doesn't matter. I don't understand.
There's so many ways to debate it. Like, for example, some people have argued, AOC, first of all, we don't really need your help. You just trying to play politics, number one. So, you know where I stand. AOC, please don't come in my neighborhood. I don't want to see you passing out no water bottles. That's number one. Number two, it was already getting warm by the time you showed up.
Well, that's how she was able to get here, because otherwise you couldn't have any, there was no flights landing here.
Exactly. Ya pa que, AOC. We just know. And then number three, her district is over there by the Bronx. Ain't that where Cuomo killed all the old people? So shouldn't you be worried about that, AOC? We got it over here. We taking care, we good. Lights back on.
What a great point, actually. Shouldn't that? I like how they just shifted because there was some attention obviously being put on Cuomo for what was going on. And as soon as Ted Cruz fucking hopped that flight, all of the attention just shifted over to him.
I mean, that's how the media works, man. You're not really getting what you need to be hearing. They decide what you need to be focused on. So they're just going to make, Senator Ted Cruz, did y'all want this man up on a power line? Like, is it his job? He don't even work over there at ERCOT. He don't work at Reliant, NRG, CenterPoint. He don't work for HLMP. None of these motherfuckers. He don't work over there. He's a senator. So, I mean, didn't we learn in 2020 that you can work and do your job from Zoom? Ted Cruz, they got Zoom in Cancun, player. We ain't mad at you. Go over there, hop on the Zoom, shit. Be like, oh, this is a fake background. It's green screen. I'm cold. That's what he should have did, right?
That's true. I like how we said we're going to hop back on here and just kind of like ease into it, shoot the shit a little bit. So as you can see, guys, this episode is going to be probably around 2 hours long, and we're going to give it away as the entire public episode. So we're going to restructure some of the Patreon. So we're going to keep it really simple. We had added other tiers, right, to give other people just more because they decided to up their pledge. But we also want to make sure that everybody that signs up for the $5 tier, which is the entry to the TIA, gets a lot of stuff. They get a lot of content. They get a lot of extras. They get, you know, Chingo using the basically, it's like a stories feature on Patreon. The lens feature. and you're all part of the TIA. I like the idea of everyone feeling like they're getting every cent of their $5 worth on the TIA tier.
I'm gonna post to the lens right now.
Right meow.
Here we go. Boom, boom, boom. What up, folks? We're recording live right now. It's going down right now as we speak. This is a 2-hour episode coming up. When does this go up?
Wednesday the 24th.
Wednesday the 24th. Shout out to the patrons. Sass. See? Boom. Now let me make sure my internet works.
I know, right? Earlier, everybody, when Chingo did that story, he's like, he went off on that beautiful, beautiful rant.
Beautiful. It was perfect.
45 minutes later, they hadn't uploaded because he closed the app too soon. The Wi-Fi is weak back here.
No, está cabrón. You know, it's because, see, we got that good insulation down here. That's what it is.
Is that what it is?
It's that good insulation, baby. It's how you spin it. Is it weak internet or is it good insulation?
I mean, I don't want to call out the studio, but when I walk in here for the first time after the freeze, I think that's why the printer broke, and I think the monitor took a long time to turn on because it was so cold.
I'm just saying. Oh, do you think that's what fucked up the printer?
Kind of. Because I have it at the house. I haven't... Because I changed the power supplies. Anyway, this is like merch stuff, but I don't know. It's unfortunate.
It's still not working. It's RIP.
Yeah, because those printers are expensive.
Patreon.com/RedPillTamales.
We're going to have some exclusive merch coming for you guys, too, pretty soon. Probably as soon as like the next week or two.
Yeah.
And you guys will have access. You guys will have the best deals on all the gear.
Mm-hmm.
On all the TIA gear.
Yep. And if you're on the road, if you come to one of the shows, we always bring merch, hats and shirts and stuff.
Yeah.
And CDs. I think in San Angelo, everybody gets an album, a copy of the album Versace Mariachi, which is jamming, by the way. I just need to promote it more. And, you know, but I am kind of shadow banned and canceled. They call me Gringo Bling and shit. They call me a trumper. Because I guess Biden is so fucking great.
There was another one. These people thought they were so clever. It was like white wing bling.
Right wing bling, yeah.
Yeah, right wing.
I bet I block your puss ass.
I said a white wing because we're talking about white people so much.
But that's how they see it. Like one person said, you have to decide who you're down with. Is it the tamales you love or something? Are you one of these crazy Republicans who love their guns or something like that? And I'm like, you know, you can like both.
Yo, did you tell me about this? Sorry, I just totally sparked another idea, another thing. The Out on Disney. Were you and I talking about that?
I saw a screenshot.
Did you look at what it was?
I read the description on the show. Like the person, I don't know if it's a boy, a teenager, like has a secret. But soon it won't be a secret much longer or something.
Yeah. And it's a super short. Like Disney has those little things where it's like a tiny, like probably 10-minute little short. But the fact that it's just on our kids' fucking, you know, front page of their thing, they might, I mean, our kids still don't control the TV, but if they were just to just turn it on or whatever, Out is a 2020 American animated short film directed by Stephen Hunter, produced by Max Whatever, distributed by Pixar. The plot features a young gay man who has not yet come out to his parents, who unexpectedly has his mind magically swapped with his dog. The seventh short film.
He's a gay dog.
In the Spark short series, I guess it's a series, is both Disney and Pixar's first short to feature a gay main character and storyline, including an on-screen same-sex kiss. The short was released on Disney Plus May 22nd of 2020.
Is they trying to make history? I don't know.
Okay, well, that's Out, literally, on Disney Plus.
But yeah, you know, that's your business. We don't care about people's sexual preferences and stuff. Find it interesting that I guess Pixar and Disney, maybe they were like trying to cover their bases. Like, hey, we haven't done something about this. I don't know. Je ne sais pas. I know they're busy canceling Gina Carano. I do know that.
Yeah, I never started The Mandalorian, and now I can't. Now I refuse to. I'm not going to watch it.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I never really had any desire.
I like Star Wars.
Yeah.
I play as Boba Fett on Fortnite whenever I have time to play.
You do what with Fortnite?
I play as Boba Fett, the bounty hunter.
You know, I've never played Fortnite before in my life.
We got to get Chingo Bling on everybody.
I need a gaming situation. I need to hit my homeboy at GameStop, see what it do.
Trying to get some of that stock or what? Trying to get up on...
Well, my homeboy that works for GameStop, he hit me up about doing like a charity thing where I would be gaming and almost like a telethon. They were going to raise money for like St. Jude's or some children's hospital and all this. But I was in the process of being canceled. It was around election time. So I was like, hey, man, I want to do this charity thing, but like I don't even own a video game console. Like, we didn't even get that far in the discussion. I was just occupied. occupied blocking people. But hey, enjoy your Harris presidency. What's the Vegas odds on when Harris takes over?
I'm still saying that by the end of the year. So like New Year's 2022, we're going to celebrate a whole new year and we're going to celebrate her. Yas, queen.
I've heard different theories. I've heard my boy Javi was like, they're going to keep him in the whole 4 years because they know everyone's placing these bets and everyone's trying to speculate like how much longer till just Harris just takes over. And then I heard someone else say they're not going to put her in until like the deep state and the establishment is done setting up all the crazy shit they want to set up, because with Joe, it's just automated. It's just like, tell me what to sign, tell me what to say. There, the homeboy was saying that with her, she might ask more questions, or she might be like, hey, should we be doing this? Or or what's the long-term repercussions?
Joe. All right.
Come in.
Yeah. All right, this time for real, it's the ending of the show.
Yeah. All right, guys. So we hope you enjoyed this episode of the Red Pill Tamales. I am your host, Chingo Bling.
And you can find us at Red Pill Tamales on Patreon. Just search it. Search Chingo Bling or go to redpilltamales.com/redpilltamales.
Yeah, and keep spreading the word, man. And let us know what you want more of. Don't forget, we're going to be all over this Patreon app using the lens feature, which is like the story. Tell a friend. Share them if you like the clips. If you like, man, remember that dude Chingo Bling? Yeah, man, whatever happened to that man? He over there spitting some real shit.
Spitting fire like Pitbull.
Know what I'm talking about? Thank you guys for tuning in. See you later. Sass.